What a show we got coming up right here. Okay, here we go. Now, here comes the greatest show on earth.
I'm coming. Yeah, greatest show. Yeah.
We are going to Madison Square Garden, where once a month they put on this marvelous show, and the other night they featured a death duel to the finish between the Iron Sheik and Sergeant Slaughter, two arch rivals. Now, of course, the Iron Sheik is managed by the great Freddie Blassie. So here we go, to the Garden, to Freddie Blassie, the Iron Sheik, and Sergeant Slaughter.
Yeah.
All right, we're in Madison Square Garden now, just a few moments really before the All-Star Wrestling Finals, and I'm with one of the all-time champs. He's retired now, he's old, he's tired, and he's the manager of the Sheik. But I'm speaking, of course, to our old friend, Freddie Blassie. It's nice. He's counting his money. You're going to lose it all tonight on the Sheik.
Ha! You pencil neck geek, you know, last night, Larry, what you said about me. You called me old. I'm retired, but I'm not old.
Freddie, there was a time when you were king here.
That's right. Right in this ring here, I drew the largest crowds wrestling has ever had.
You were the greatest.
That's right. By all means.
You wrestled Bruno?
I wrestled Bruno Sammartino.
Did you beat him?
I certainly did. Well, you just named him, and I wrestled him and beat him.
You beat him all, right?
I beat Mr. Moto, I beat Buddy Austin, and...
And you wore that crown?
Oh.
You were beautiful.
I certainly was. I agree with you. I mean, I went all out. And without a doubt, every year I was voted the most hated man in the world. And I loved it, because I can readily understand why these pencil-neck geeks were envious of the great Freddie Blassie.
You were good-looking, you
That's
had
right.
money, you had everything.
And I still got money.
And you still got money, too.
How do you like this latest edition? 16 carat.
Come on, Fred.
16 carat.
Fred, a guy was selling that this afternoon on the sidewalk.
Is that right? Take a look at it. Isn't that a little gem?
Just tell me about the Sheik. He's your guy tonight.
The Sheik is the greatest wrestler in the world.
Really?
Handled by your steward. The man is Young Crown World Heavyweight Champion. In fact, he had the World Heavyweight title, and he was jobbed out of it by these pencil-neck aches here in the East. But I guarantee you, he's back on a road.
You have passed on all your knowledge to the Sheik?
Everything.
All right. Will you introduce me to him? Can I meet him?
I certainly will.
Is he a nice guy?
Well, he's like Freddie Blassie was in his heyday.
Oh, tell the Sheik to take it easy, will you?
Well, the Sheik will do what I tell him.
Okay, let's go meet him, all right?
Oh, certainly, certainly.
All right,
Eat your heart out there, you pencil neck geeks. Eat your heart out. These are $100 bills, you know, and there's not one of them. Take a look. Take a look. You don't see no measly 10, 20 in there, or 50.
You pencil neck geek with a
That's
single
right.
fuck in your pocket.
That's
we got
right.
big money.
16 carats, too.
16 carats right here.
That's right.
Let's go meet the
four
Sheik.
Four Lincolns at home, too.
Hey, four Lincolns, not three. We
That's
got four.
Right.
We want the Sheik. Let's go get him. Pick up your purse, Freddie, and let's
right.
go.
You know what I'm talking about. I'm talking to you, you pencil neck geek. You know what I'm talking about? Listen to what I tell you. We're going to go meet the Sheik now, the number one wrestler in the world, managed by yours truly, Freddie Blassie.
Okay, here we are. Here's Freddie and the Sheik in a last-minute conference now before the big match tonight. Sheik Regis Philbin.
And that's the Iron Sheik from Tehran, Iran. Without a doubt, the greatest wrestler in the world today, Regis. This man here is just sensational.
Yeah. But now, Sheik, what has Freddie taught you?
Well, Ayatollah Blassie, one of the best managers in this country. I come from Tehran, Iran. This man, he's a real one of the best managers in this country. He taught me everything I know about professional wrestling, because I was the AAU champion, I was the Olympic champion, Asian champion, and Moscow Olympic Games 68, Mexico City, anything you name it about amateur, I was the best. And also I come to pro professional wrestling, toughest sport in the world, and this man was the first manager in the world to help me to I get that world heavyweight belt champion. And was the biggest pleasure for me to Ayatollah Blassie be as my manager.
What's he saying, Fred?
Just a minute. He spoke in your language, now he's going to speak in his.
خدمت همه شنوندگان ایرانی عزیز سلام عرض می‌کنم که در نیویورک سیتی زندگی می‌کنن همه دنیا پهلوانای ایران می‌شناسه خصوصاً غلامرضای تختی درود به خاک غلامرضای تختی همه دنیا
نو Now here.
What do you guys do just before you go out? Is there a certain routine you go
yes,
through?
Yes, I told him. I told him. I said, you've wrestled this Sergeant Slaughter three times. Three times you've had your hand raised in a token of victory, and I hate odd numbers. So tonight, make it even. Uh-huh. That means number four. And the man is. These are the most sacred things in Iran. His prayer beads. Uh-huh. And a man is every time that he's in a dressing room, sitting down, and he has a second's time, he has his beads out praying.
Now, do you two pray together?
Well. He's trying.
As his manager, Fred, you should pray with him.
I do.
Can we have a little demo? Can we see how you pray together?
Well,
first of all, before I do my prayer, I want to tell to all the American people, Sergeant Slaughter, you come from South Carolina, USA. I come from Tehran, Iran, 10,000 miles. From A to the Z, I get it. And I was it. I was the first Iranian world heavyweight champion in this country. Sergeant Slaughter, I want to know what Olympic you win.
Well, the man talks about coming 10,000 miles to fight somebody. Well, you don't have to go anywhere. I've been looking all over the country for the biggest dump I can find. The biggest junkyard. The biggest dump. And I'm going to put a big plaque on it. And we're going to call it the Unknown Iranian. And we're going to stick you in it, Iron Sheik, because we don't want you around here. This is the U.S. of A. U.S. of A.
What do you get tonight? Madison Square Garden. I swear to
God. I don't like it when he gets excited. Here comes the prayer. I think we're going to pray.
Remember, I come from 10,000 miles, Tehran, Iran. همه دنیا پهلوانای ایرانو میشناسه. مخصوصا خسرو وزیری.
What's he saying?
Sergeant Slaughter, I'm not done with you.
I don't need any help from anybody. I never needed anybody to help me win a match. I never needed anybody help to take me over to Vietnam and fight and have these scars on my body. I'm a survivor, Mr. Feldman. I'm a survivor because I'm here to tell you about it.
Soldier Slaughter, you're nothing except pig, you American hog. Ach, go!
Hey!
Fred, be a soldier. Go.
Fred, Freddy, control them, will you?
I am not going to do anything. You were the one that got them all riled up.
I didn't say what I said. Was how, you know.
He said you look a little bit like Sergeant Slaughter, and I feel sorry for you.
Are you a Marine Corps veteran?
That's right.
Were you a sergeant in the Marines?
Sergeant.
No.
Drill instructor.
How many years were you in?
7 years. How many years have you been holding that microphone?
Why is the sergeant turning on me? What have I got to do with
it? You like the cobra clutch on you?
All I did was tell you that the Iron Sheik is looking
would
for you.
Would you like the slaughter cannon across your head?
What is that, the slaughter cannon?
The slaughter cannon. It's getting loaded right now. I might just give you one right now. I'm not sure yet.
I'm just telling you, the Iron Sheik's got Freddie Blassie on his side.
Freddie Blassie's a traitor, American traitor, and the way it sounds, you are too.
I've got
nothing to do. Freddie Blassie?
I don't know Freddie Blassie.
You're going to have appetizers with Blassie before I get done with you. Appetizers with Blassie.
Are you predicting victory tonight?
Victory all the way. USA number one. What else can I say?
All right, Sergeant. Good luck to you.
I hope this is in friendship.
God bless you.
All right. God bless America.
There you have it. The Iron Sheik and Sergeant Slaughter. Now they met in the ring and they really went at it. And guess what happened, folks? A double disqualification. No winner this time around. Thereby ensuring a bigger gate for the next time around. Anyway, it was great fun. Hope you enjoyed it. Coming right back now with a biofeedback test, so stay with us. Thank you, Freddie, and thank you, Iron Sheik. Thank you, Sergeant.
How are you? Regis, how are you?
Wonderful. How are you? Had any kids lately?
And the cowboy, right?
Ace.
Ace.
I always got an ace in the hole.
Now, look, how does it feel to be the biggest villain in America right now?
Villain? My mom don't think so. I feel great. I'm in the pink. Are you kidding me, man?
How come they didn't invite you to do Saturday Night Live?
They took second choice. I said, I'll mail it in, and that's exactly what I did.
You got any surprises today for Mr. T? I know you really want Mr.
Well,
T.
Well, I got in the sun lamp, so he'd feel comfortable trying to get as dark as I could. Just so he'd feel comfortable. But we didn't think we'd shade sides of Ace's hand.
Now, you know what I think's going to happen here?
You're going to have to cut that out, aren't you?
We all know you. Yeah. But now, listen, I think that the Ace has got something in here. It's a little surprise for all of us.
Yeah, we'll check it out. Yeah, an arm. Big bones.
You have pretty good spirits going into this thing, eh? You must be pretty confident.
Oh, yeah. I'm not supposed to walk into a fight with tears in my eyes, man. Yeah.
But the Hulkster's angry this time.
Oh, he's losing more hair. That makes you lose more hair, Honky Baby.
Listen, he don't like it when you make fun of his hair.
Yeah, that breaks my heart. That breaks my heart.
And Mr. T is flexing all the time.
You've been making lots of money, too, haven't you? Does your wife hold on to those?
But you're a little on the chubby side, too.
Chubby, you sucker. I'll eat your lunch. Yeah. Hey,
but I love you. I love you on the air. You're the greatest. There's nobody like you. Your little kilts and everything.
You're not saying that because
you're absolutely phenomenal.
How come you're so jumpy?
I'm a little jumpy around here.
You're not afraid of me, are you? You said you should be.
Yeah. Yeah, like when you get
angry. With him standing behind me.
Yeah. What happened? Yeah. He's got a little shiner here.
That's a hit.
You bite as much as I do, you get her one.
Yeah. Yeah, like when you get angry.
With him standing behind me.
Yeah. What happened? Yeah. He's got a little shiner here.
That's a hit.
You bite as much as I do, you get her once in a while.
You still fighting with that injury?
Of course.
Yeah. Well, where's Mr. Wonderful? Where's Paul?
Paul's coming. Understand how tough we are. You know, this is minor. Minor. Who cares?
Yeah, really.
You guys are really that tough, huh?
Yes, absolutely.
Where's Mr. Wonderful? He's not here yet. He's afraid.
Well, where was Mr. T at the last press conference? Trying to pretend he's a Mohican. Yeah. Paul. Yeah, never mind. Yeah, but Mr. Wonderful's coming in on an airplane from Atlanta. He's due to arrive here at 12 something, so he's probably...
You ready to go now? You're predicting victory or not?
No, I'm going to go in there and lose. You ribbing me? Of course I'm predicting victory. This is the biggest thing that's ever happened, ever in this sport.
The major upset if you guys could beat Mr. T and... I mean it. Everybody, the whole country's rooting for them, except me. I want you guys to win.
I thought we'd have a little tag team match, Animal, and I get Ira Joe, but Ira's not here today either.
You, Regis, and the Animal.
Then let's go at it. I hear that bell again? We spent $150 to rent this bell. When did you hear this? Go ahead.
Get on the mat, geek.
Did he call me a geek? Hey, hey, hey! Hey, Oklahoma, come here. Come here. Here's my tag team partner. Guy from the audience. What's your name, pal?
Gene Young.
Good, Gene. Go get him.
What's the good?
Just.
He's not very friendly. Okay.
You grab one arm and I'll grab the other after you grab yours.
Put me out of it. He's coming after
us. Come on, we only got 30. Oh. Easy, 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 easy. Hey! That's it. You gotta get it now. Get up, Gene. Go get him. This guy's crazy. This guy's nuts. We'll be right back with more of a... Where's your buddy?
Busy.
9:15 on a Monday morning, what could he possibly be doing?
He had a fun night.
Wrestling... Bigger and better than ever, the, what was that major event? The WrestleMania 5 was the biggest of all time. And now comes SummerSlam on August 28th, the Meadowlands over in New Jersey. It's the big wrestling event of the summer. Now, there's more to this sport than just the wrestlers themselves. There are the managers who are every bit as colorful as the guys that they manage.
One of them is Bobby the Brain Heenan, reportedly the smartest of all the managers, has guys like Ravishing Rick Rude and Andre the Giant, and the Brain Busters has a veritable arsenal of talent under his command. He's quite a character, has his own TV show, and here he is, ladies and gentlemen, a big hand for Bobby the Brain Heenan. How are you, Bob? Nice to see you. I'm sorry that part of the audience yelled out, Weasel, Weasel, Weasel.
Well, somebody made bail.
Bobby, it's good to have you on our show.
Of course.
I've admired your work for a long time. But tell me this, what exactly does a manager in wrestling do?
Well, what I do is I do all the negotiations contract-wise for my men. I book them. I handle percentage of their money. I handle, make sure they get their percentage, uh-huh. Not that I'm skimming off the top or nothing. And I make sure that their travel arrangements are set up and their hotel accommodations, and they get a fair shake.
And you do a good job.
I do a great job.
And your guys, it's called the Heenan family, mm-hmm. And they love you.
Well, a lot of people like to call who they manage a stable of champions. To me, a stable is a place where fly-infested horses live.
Yes.
I have a family group. We're knitted together. We all think alike. We all care for each other.
And they love you, you know.
Oh, wow.
And they would die for you. As a matter of fact, well, now here's an example of that. Here's one of his wrestlers. Here is the Red Rooster embracing Bobby the Brain Heenan. Loves him.
Wait a minute. You have to understand something here.
What?
I had just fired this man.
Oh, I see.
See, I had just dumped this ham and egger.
Bobby, look what he's doing to you. Look out!
I think that's very nice to show something
no,
like this.
No, but I mean, that's what happened.
No, what happened was I took this guy. He's a mediocre athlete. He had limited ability, limited thinking. And I took him and I made him a star. And he wasn't doing what I thought was right. George Steinbrenner was sitting ringside the night. I asked George, I said, what do you do with a guy like this? He said, fire him. So I called him outside and I slapped him in the face.
Was it your idea to put the red in his hair?
No, it wasn't my idea at all. If he wants to look stupid, that's his own idea.
Now, has he suffered because he's no longer in your family?
He's become a very big star in the World Wrestling Federation. Financially, I don't know how he's doing. I mean, how much money can you spend in a barnyard?
Yeah, but the guy...
That's kind of foul, isn't it?
Bobby, you're hot. You know, Bobby, I see you on cable with Gorilla Monsoon. You guys have a two-hour show. You don't need the gorilla.
No, I got my own talk show now. I dumped him. He can go peel bananas for all I care. I don't need him.
You don't need him.
No, I never needed him. I just carried him.
You actually did.
Yeah, that's why I'm here, helping you out.
Okay, I appreciate that. You think I can make it, Bobby, with your managing? Do you think I could be somebody in the WWF?
Yeah, because I understand now that the guy that used to fold towels quit.
Bobby!
No, with your mind, you could do it. With your mind and your talent.
I'm smarter than those guys.
Oh, of course you're smarter than those guys. You have me as a guest.
That's right. Now, here is Ravishing Rick Rude, who incidentally is one of my favorites. This guy is probably one of the best built bodies you've ever seen. He's been trained very enthusiastically
by Bobby. He makes the guys at Chippendale wear smocks.
That's right. Now they have a thing. After the Brain disposes, I'm sorry, the Rude, Rick Rude disposes of his opponent in the ring, you call up for some young lady to come out of the audience and have a Rude awakening.
Well, we previously had selected about 20 of them who have been begging the whole evening to have the Rude awakening, and then we picked the lucky lady so he can have a little recreational time.
Was that your idea?
No, it was Ravishing Rick Rude. He's a very generous man.
And when he kisses them, they are almost rendered unconscious.
Yes, you do have to call the 911 number.
Oh, my gosh. So, all right, well, let's take a look, and we'll see what this is all about. Here is the Rude
this is
awakening.
Another trick piece of film.
No.
Well, it's that all-important time again. And are you ready to make some lovely lady delirious with happiness with the Rude awakening?
Ready and willing, Bobby. As if this is a big deal. It's supposed to be a thrill.
Enjoy yourself.
Oh, my goodness.
We've got another winner!
There won't be any Rude awakening of this kind after the Warrior match at WrestleMania.
And the rest of you ready? Eat your heart.
Bobby, even I got a blush when I see that. Now, whose choreography was that?
Oh, that's his own. Every movement he does is his own. Yeah.
Do these women actually fall in love with the Rude Awakening?
Some have left their husbands and families, yes. The divorce rate is up.
Well, you guys are having a ball out there, aren't you? Huh?
Well, we have our big Summer Slam coming up on the 28th of August from the Meadowlands.
Any matches been signed yet that you can tell us about?
Yes, I can discuss one. You know, Hulk Hogan has a big hit movie out, No Holds Barred.
Yes.
And the star of the movie is Hulk Hogan, so he says. But I think the man named Zeus.
Oh, I love Zeus. I love Zeus.
Zeus is 6 feet 11. He weighs 385 pounds, and he will be teamed with Randy Macho Man Savage.
Wow.
To go against Hulk Hogan and Brutus Beefcake.
Oh, my God.
At the Meadowlands, the 28th.
That's going to be a great event.
It's also available on pay-per-view television. Check your cable systems.
Yeah.
And, yeah, it'll be something. Oh, Zeus and him, I guess, had a lot of friction during the making of the movie. Zeus understood he was the star of the movie. You know Hogan, he's a big loudmouth, and I hate a loudmouth.
Yeah.
And he tried to take over everything, and I guess there was a little, they had to separate him a couple times.
Oh, my gosh. Well, let's take a look now at the Brainbusters. Okay, I got to get these guys in. The Brainbusters are his tag team match. Now, they're not the biggest guys, but they're the smartest ones, aren't they?
Well, Arn Anderson and Tully Blanchard.
Now, look at
right
that.
There.
Oh. Yeah. So this guy's out. He's out cold.
He had 48 Excedrin before the morning. Good looking guys, too.
Oh, they're good looking guys, yeah. There they are, the Brainbusters.
Here are your winners, Tully Blanchard and
Arn. Like team champions
and
of the
look
world.
At another outfit, yet another outfit. They're great. But I want you to know that my own particular tag team favorites are the Bushwhackers.
No.
Not a day goes by, Bobby, that I don't walk around the studio with my cohort over here, and we do the Bushwhackers. Come on, back. Well, they are the next champions. Play that tape for us, will you? Let's take a look at the Bushwhackers in action right here. Here they come. There's the next champions. Going to walk. And they get him.
Good looking, guys.
And here comes the walk.
I don't know if many people know this or not.
Audience loves it. There they go.
Did you know the Bushwhackers are living proof that the Three Stooges did have children? Not many people know that.
Oh, gosh. Brain, it's good to have you here. You look terrific.
I feel
congratulations
terrific.
On getting your own show and moving Monsoon out of there.
And you can be a guest if you like.
I'd love to be a guest on your
show.
Anytime
I'll see if I can
call.
Work you in.
Okay, fine. And don't forget the big Summer Slam over at the Meadowlands in New Jersey on August 28th. Thank you very much.
My
Bobby
pleasure.
The Brain Heenan, everybody. Yeah. We'll be back in a moment.
Tomorrow on Live, the Crosby Show's Malcolm Jamal Warner.
Lucky. Also, Ravishing Rick Rude.
Now, wait, before we go past Ravishing Rick Rude, let's say SummerSlam is tonight over in the Meadowlands.
Yeah.
This is the, you know, the WrestleMania 4 and 5. Well, now this is the summer version of that. They've got tremendous matches. Zeus versus the Hulk. We got Brutus versus Macho Man. And Sensational Sherry's here. But a great match is Rick Rude versus the Ultimate Warrior. Rick Rude, after he disposes of the guy in the ring, he stands in front of the audience in the arena. And Bobby the Brain comes in and says, all right, would one of you ladies like your own special Rude Awakening? That means a major kiss. And they come up, and Rick Rude puts a kiss on them. They usually faint. We're going to try to do that in our... not with this audience, but we'll try to do that later on. Yeah, Bobby the Brain will be here, too. And what else do we have? Yeah, that's right. Okay. Here he is, the Intercontinental Wrestling Champion of the World in action tonight against the Ultimate Warrior in SummerSlam over in the Meadowlands. Here's Ravishing Rick Rude.
Thank you.
Oh, Rick.
Thank you,
Rick's
Rick.
Looking you over. You know how lucky you are that he kissed your hand?
Really?
Rick. Rick.
Rick.
It's nice to have you all ready to go against the Warrior tonight.
All set for the Warrior. You know, up until this point, my mind has been focused totally on the Ultimate Warrior. But Kathy Lee, you've seemed to have done away with that. My mind's off in left field somewhere.
The Ultimate Woman right here, Rick.
You got it.
This is what the belt looks like.
How this is, so, would you like to hold
is it?
Like
heavy?
Is it heavy?
Look. There it is, pal. That's what it's all about.
In your dreams.
What?
Do you wish you had one of these?
I really do, Rick. I really do.
Well, then you can have it for this short time.
Oh, good. Maybe it'll help my bad.
It'll make your dreams come true, too. Right.
This is what you need, though. You need a velvet robe with
sequins.
You see,
this guy is the best built of all of the wrestlers. The Ultimate Warrior is pretty well built, too. But Rick Rude's got a tremendous physique, and he's got great sex appeal, as you can see.
Yeah. How tall are you, Rick?
6'4". How tall are you, Kathy?
I'm short. I'm really short. I have stubs for legs, but 6'4", that's big.
Those don't look like no stubs I've ever seen before.
You know, I really, honest to God, I sense something going on here. Frank is out of town, isn't he?
Yeah.
Anyway, Rick, what is this magic thing? I mean, here, you know, the Brain comes into the ring with you, your manager, and you ask some lady who would like a rude awakening, and they come right up and get in the ring with you, and I've never seen anything like it.
You've never seen anything like it? You've led a sheltered life, Regis.
I guess I have.
He has.
You know, the fact of the matter is this. My mother taught me when I was very young that love is a thing to be spread. So that's just my little way of spreading a little bit of love throughout the country wherever I go.
He's the one that started it.
Yeah. Okay, well, let's watch Rick spread a little love right now. Here's a typical scene, a wrestling arena. I guess the match is just starting, or maybe it's just over. Kids, don't watch this clip. It's a little rough.
Isn't this the greatest thrill in your life, to be in the same ring and to be able to have the rude awakening by the Intercontinental Champion?
Yes, it is.
Help yourself, Toots.
Okay, now, our microphones are open. Let's talk about this. The Brain has to hold the belt. Now watch this, Kathy. He takes a look at it. He's not going to kiss anybody. Uh-oh.
My
gosh. Uh-oh.
She's melting, Regis.
She's melting. She's out. She's unconscious.
Wait a minute. Hold it. There you go. Yeah.
I haven't seen anything like that since you danced with the Chippendale.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
You know,
yeah.
We're going to try to duplicate that. We've got the Brain back there. We're going to bring him out, and we're going to see if anybody in our audience...
I don't think so. I'll go check on Bobby.
No, wait a minute. No, you sit right here. It could be you. We don't know what's going to happen, but we'll be right back in a moment.
It won't be my sweetheart down in New Orleans. We'll be right back.
Coming Thursday on Live, Dear John's Jerry Burns.
Okay, we are back now, and let's bring out Rick Rude's wonderful manager. You all know him, of course, Bobby the Brain Heenan. Here he is.
No, not now.
Hi, Brain.
How do you do?
How you doing?
Bobby.
My pleasure. How are you?
Bobby, we got something going here.
Joanne's back there, one of your production, says she's begging to come out here. She wants the rude awakening.
Yeah, this guy is looking her over, and he's making her very nervous. The woman's coming unglued. I think you'd like the rude awakening.
I think Kathy Lee needs a rude awakening.
Kathy Lee's had a few rude awakenings.
Not this rude, Kathy. Yeah.
Well, Brain, tell us now. These women, you've never failed, right? Someone has always gotten up and gotten into the ring.
Well, you know, I have a production staff that goes out and picks out 30 to 45 of them, and then we select the one we want that evening.
Oh,
sometimes we go to, there are no selections. They just don't rank. They just don't make it.
Oh.
And tonight at the middle ends, you people that get that will subscribe to pay-per-view will be able to sit at home and watch it. You that are in the middle ends will be able to see Ravishing Rick Rude do it. Can we have a cold towel out here for Kathy Lee?
Should be a big night for the pay-per-view. What is going on here?
I don't know.
Is it warm in here? Is Kathy Lee brought the temperature up 10 degrees?
Kathy, would you like me and Regis to leave?
Yeah. No!
You can go do something.
No, don't leave.
Why don't you guys sit on the couch? We'll sit here and talk a little bit.
But here's what gets me. The rude one is really intrigued.
And you don't see him like that too often.
Not
He's very picky.
No, just like every night.
You know, over the airways, I could see that Kathy Lee was the most beautiful woman on television. But now as I draw closer in person, I just can't believe it. You know, there's no tickets available live at the Meadowland tonight, But I think maybe as my guest, Kathy Lee, I can get you in and pretty good seats on top of it.
But it's Monday Night Football night.
That's okay.
We'll bring one of those little TVs for you.
You can watch it on TV then.
After halftime, you won't care.
Brain, we are going to turn it over to you, and we're going to see who we can get out of our audience.
Now, there's a woman up there. Did you check this lady out?
He checked everybody out.
It's nice.
We have a lady already selected. Go ahead. Donna Nuzzo. You're going to have to come down. Not you, pal. Put your hand down. You. The guy that thought he won before, she's raising his hand. Now, are you ready for probably the greatest event in your life? Are you sure?
Now, wait a minute. She looks like she's a lot of woman.
She is a lot of woman.
Well, if there's not enough, we have more in the audience.
Can you take the robe off, Rick?
Stick around.
I'll leave the robe on right now, Regis.
Back up. We need some room here.
Oh, I like the twirl. That's nice.
Ah, we have another winner.
The rope's got to come off. No rope.
That's how you hurt your back. Are you ready for something special now?
Now what happens?
Well, we call 9-11 for her. And now a little extra treat for everybody. Ooh. And I want Regis, you over there, and Kathy, I'd like you to stand over there, please.
Over
there. Right between the cameras there.
Okay.
Okay, you ready for this? Hit the music.
All right, I did my little thing for the lovely lady
yes.
from the crowd. Tonight, I'm going to do the thing for the warrior at the SummerSlam.
That's it.
But right now...
Wait till you see this.
Right here.
Go ahead.
No!
This one is for the Giffer.
We'll be back. Bobby, thanks so much for coming by.
My pleasure.
Good luck, Rick. Looking dead tonight,
she moves
okay?
Fast.
Yeah, we'll get her
out. Pay-per-view tonight, Meadowlands.
Pay-per-view at the Meadowlands, and we'll be back in a moment. We've got Mr. Perfect, but here's the guy who is sort of his mentor, his advisor, and his admirer. Here's the genius. Genius, how are you?
Hi, my wife.
Come on.
How are you?
Sit down. Yes. Look how beautiful he is. This genius. Yes. It's nice to have you here. Genius, I take it from the way you're clutching that you have written a poem for the occasion.
I thank you, Joy and Regis, for that lovely introduction. You know how to make a genius feel at home. But I came here to talk about a man who is to wrestling what Romulus and Remus were to Rome. It takes a real genius to appreciate perfection. Mr. Perfect is perfection at its best. By the power of the genius and the world's smartest man, let me introduce a very perfect guest. Ladies and gentlemen, tonight in Madison Square Garden, we will have a new Perfect World Wrestling Federation Heavyweight Champion. And now, if you are quite ready, the genius presents Mr. Perfect.
Have a seat, Mr. Perfect.
Let me move my chair. Make plenty of room.
Joy wants to know why Mr. Perfect is all wet.
Well,
He's been a couple hundred push-ups back.
Couple of hundred push-ups, getting ready for tonight's bout,
absolutely.
Right?
Absolutely.
Yeah, it's going to be a tough one.
Probably the toughest match I've ever had in my career. Sure. Everybody knows what Hulk Hogan is to the World Wrestling Federation, but the time has come. I paid my dues. I have my credentials.
That's right.
And I will be the next World Wrestling Federation.
Now, is this what we're wearing tonight?
Very good possibility.
Yeah, orange looks good on Mr. Perfect.
Do you have those in all colors, Mr. Perfect? I mean, the suit.
Curious, huh?
You're curious, aren't you, Joey? If this is the kind of guy you should have married,
because he's perfect. Right?
You want to know something? He is perfect in everything he does. But let's give you a little background to this tonight's battle. And incidentally, we've got the Royal Rumble coming up too. We'll talk about that in a second. But now wait a minute. It was the Genius who took on Hulk Hogan, didn't he, on Saturday Night Wrestling? Yeah. And as a matter of fact, let's take a look at that clip right now. Here's the Hulk and the Genius in the ring. We'll show you what happened. We'll talk about it, too, if
the battle goes on.
Genius not doing too well right here. Hulk throwing the Genius out. But wait a minute. Watch what happens. Look at the Hulk. Now, there's his buddy, Mr. Perfect.
Like throwing him out of the ring.
Actually threw the Genius right out. Now watch what happens here. Hulk's going
to
leave the ring, go down, and throws Mr. Perfect out of the way. He should have never thrown, he should have never put his hands on you. He had no business doing that. He throws the Genius back in the ring, but watch what happens.
Well, here's your belt, Hulk. If you want it here, how about it?
Hey! He hits Hulk Hogan with his own championship belt, knocking him down, rendering him unconscious. And what happened then, Genius?
The Genius was victorious. And you know what I've noticed?
What's that?
Two things since my victory over Hulk Hogan.
What?
False friends and true enemies.
Oh, really? Everybody jealous of you, in other words, huh?
Can you blame them?
How did you two guys get together anyway? Well, I mean,
there's a lot of people ask a lot of questions about the Genius.
Yes.
What his wrestling abilities are and what he exactly does for Mr. Perfect.
Yeah.
First of all, mind your own business.
I didn't think that was too personal.
But the way he looks
all great leaders in this country, or even on Star Trek, Captain Kirk.
Yeah.
He had Mr. Spock. Nobody questioned him.
That's right.
Right. He's my advisor.
Okay.
I've covered so much ground. I'm doing so many different things. And being absolutely perfect, I don't want to miss a thing.
Oh. But have you noticed the way he looks at you?
No, but you have.
I never... Look at him.
Look at the way he's looking at
Regis.
You.
Regis.
Yes.
I am a monogamous heterosexual.
Yes.
Are you questioning?
No, I'm not questioning anything.
No,
I'm just saying, I think it's very touching the way you admire Mr. Perfect. And of course, you're absolutely right. He is perfect.
There's millions of other people out there that admire me, just men and women. Everywhere I go, every place I do, it's the same old thing.
Yeah.
I got to wear my hair up because when I walk through airports, people are trying,
Oh, yeah, trying to touch you.
Yeah.
Well, I got to wear my hair up, too. Listen, we're going to come right back, show you more of this in just a moment. Right back in a second. All right, we're back now with Mr. Perfect and, of course, the Genius. And let me show you what happened after that bout, which the Genius won, incidentally, because Hulk could not climb back into the ring. This is what happened in the dressing room, and this is what led up to tonight's match.
Kurt Hennig, it is one thing for Hulk Hogan to lose by virtue of a countout to the Genius. It's another thing for you to desecrate the very meaning of Hulkamania.
This has never been a perfect belt, and Hulk Hogan, you're not a perfect champion. And I'll follow you around to every arena if I have to, and I'll destroy every belt until you give me a title shot the perfect way.
There it is.
That's quite a challenge.
That is quite a challenge. Do you realize what happened here? Hulkamania was destroyed right before your eyes as you hammered that belt into submission.
That belt means as much to Hulk Hogan as all the fans and all the little Hulkamaniacs that follow him around.
Yeah.
And I knew by destroying the belt I would get his attention because he had been avoiding me for the last year. I was in the World Wrestling Federation with an undefeated record, but for some reason couldn't get a match with Hulk Hogan.
Something.
And tonight in Madison Square Garden, by the way, it's going to take place. And it's because of smashing the belt, or whatever the cause is, I'm here, the time is right, and you're going to be having a new World Wrestling Federation.
Well, I'm going to go there myself. I got to see this. And incidentally, what is it, next month, Royal Rumble?
Royal Rumble.
The 21st.
You can pick up that on your pay-per-view cable. It's going to be all over the United States.
30 guys in the ring at once. Wrestling, and whoever winds up in the ring alone is
the winner. Every 2 minutes, a new contestant comes into the ring, and the only way to be eliminated is over the top rope to the cement floor. Yeah.
and it's a perfect opportunity for me to show the whole world that 29 other men aren't perfect.
All right. Now, you have seen Mr. Perfect on television. He has an ace at basketball. He does high dives
off
the board tremendously. You know that genius. What else has he done?
Card tricks, too.
Well, he's done that. He's done bowling. I mean, he's done everything. We've rigged up a little bowling thing here. I'm going to give you a little lesson on how to bowl right now, okay? You think you're so hot, Mr. Perfect?
Find the ball that sticks. Try this one, Regis.
This one?
Yeah,
okay, fine.
It's heavy. Don't drop it.
Okay, perfect. Now watch this. Genius, you could be leaving Mr. Perfect after this, and you could be with me. No,
right.
Wait a minute. No, don't do that.
I'm going to go right between the first and the second pin.
What is this, from your old thing?
Yes, I remember. I took bowling in school.
Between the first and second pin? Are you watching, Mr. Perfect?
I'm watching.
All right, babe. Here you go.
Good, Regis.
No!
Not bad. It's a spare.
God!
You got a spare.
But I got close. I got four down, didn't I? All right, what do you got for me?
Here comes the ball. Somebody get the ball.
What do you got for me, Perfect?
I've already been on national television and bowled a perfect game.
Yeah, I know you have.
And I've already been on television, and everything else I've ever done in my life has been absolutely perfect.
Yeah?
And for me to come out here and bowl today would be senseless. Number one, you don't even have a right kind of bowling alley.
I understand that.
And I've got the biggest match of my life tonight. I didn't come out here to bowl.
Yeah, I understand.
But if you have a deck of cards, maybe I... Genius cards. You have some cards?
What are you doing? A deck of cards? Didn't know you were a card shark, too? Genius, what are you reaching for? Let's go.
Beside, he'd be amazed what he's got underneath that gown.
Okay. Pick a card.
Now watch very carefully.
The cards match his outfit, isn't it?
Oh, you are an old shark. Look.
Well, you know, I saw somebody do this once on TV. You know. Okay, pick a card. Any card to deck.
Go ahead, George. Take it.
Can you remember what it is?
No. Yeah.
Okay.
Okay. Okay, put it in.
Can I put it down
sure,
here?
Sure, put it right where I stopped.
Put it in.
Yeah, see, I know this trick.
Might have goofed me up, huh? Is that the card you just
no,
had?
That's no, that's not the card.
I
see,
that's the
it's not over.
It's not
over.
You have to shut
is that
it.
The
no,
card?
That's not the card either.
Is that the card?
You know that's not the
genius,
card.
Genius, get a new
no,
man.
No, is this the
no,
card?
No, that's not the card.
Okay, is this the card?
No.
Okay, none of them four are the card, right?
Right.
Four cards here, right?
Right.
Look at them again now. Is that your card?
No.
Okay, putting it down, I'll bring the next one up. Is that your card?
No.
These two for sure are not your card.
Right.
That's not your card.
No.
What's your card?
The Queen of Hearts.
There it is.
Queen of Diamonds. I can't believe it.
That's
the card.
Just like everything else I've done, perfect. Now you got it.
Now you know why he's Mr. Perfect and the genius.
Oh, oh.
Thank you, Mr. Perfect. Oh. Thank
good
you,
luck tonight.
Good night. Good luck.
We'll see you all tonight at Madison Square Garden.
Good night.
Cody.
I said he has Cody with him. No, it's not.
Well, it's
Cody.
All about Cody.
No, who is this? Who
this is
this? This
is my protective package there, Regis.
You know, I always said, didn't I say yesterday, the Ultimate Warrior has a link with
like
the...
Like a spirit.
Yes, with the Indian ancestors.
Well, I saw the little warrior running around back there. I'm talking about Cody.
Yeah.
And in this day, in this world, you need to do all that you can. I know he's got the perfect upbringing with you as his mother. The most beautiful television personality.
The most sweetest. The most beautiful woman on television.
On
let's
television.
Get it right, Ultimate.
I like the way he's saying it.
No challengers, no challengers. And with Frank Gifford as a father.
Yeah, that's a good part.
But I wanted to give you this for
thank
Cody.
Thank you, Ultimate.
So anytime he may feel...
Can I call you Ultimate?
You can call me whatever you want.
Thank you, that's very sweet.
You're very welcome, thank
the
you.
Little Ultimate.
The little baby
here's
Ultimate.
The big Ultimate, this is the little Ultimate.
That's really
the
great. Warrior. Are these available in stores for kids
yeah,
to buy?
Yeah, they are.
Stuff? That's
well,
great.
Ultimate,
one,
tell us
it.
About, you know what, I see you on TV, you're always, you know, you're
bigger than life.
You're bigger than life. But where are you from?
Parts unknown.
Parts unknown.
Uh-huh. It's hard to get there, too. You can't buy a plane ticket.
Yeah. And you kind of toned down the makeup. I mean, you used to be all...
In the final stages for SummerSlam, you know, 15-foot steel cage match against Rick Rude.
Steel cage, is that going to make a difference in your strategy?
No. Rick Rude has been in a lot of steel cage matches. I've been in very few. But
I'd like to hear that.
Well, I'll listen to the Warriors, and the Warriors are going to fill the arena with all that power, and leave as the champion.
Do the Warriors talk to you from upstairs? I mean, do you... Because I see you looking up there.
They talk to me from every place. They're all out there. All the Warriors. Everybody.
Now, you see, this is what I need around the arms right here. To accentuate my arms.
I've been working on a treadmill half an hour a day, but this takes how many hours a day to look like this? A
couple hours a day going to work out at the gym and stuff. And
you know, you're pretty docile today. He's almost like a nice guy. We want you tough, lean, and mean, ready for Rick Rude. Now listen,
Would you like me to body slam you?
Yes!
Body slam me?
Yeah.
Oh, thank you. Listen, Rick Rude was here on the show. He wore tights with my face in front of whatever it was.
My face was in front, your face is in the back.
Yeah,
I saw it.
And he strutted
the most beautiful woman.
And he strutted
TV.
Around here, picture. You know, and he humiliated us. Now we want you on a crusade.
You didn't stick up for yourself, Regis, or what?
Well,
thank you for bringing that up.
I did hide behind her, but I stayed here, didn't I?
And I was 2 months pregnant at the time, which was really nice.
No, when I go to the ring to do battle, it's all business.
Uh-huh.
But these people and my warriors know that I lead a life outside of that. And I wear this on my face like this as an indication that no matter where I am or what I'm doing, I feel the Warriors. And at SummerSlam, I walk to the ring as the World Wrestling Federation champion.
That's right. You beat the Hulk.
That's right. Beat Hulk Hogan, the only one to ever beat Hulk Hogan.
Couldn't believe it. I really couldn't believe it.
Hulk Hogan's still a first-class person in my book. Mm-hmm. And
but you're the champion.
I'm the World Wrestling Federation
champion.
And
now the Rude wants your belt.
Well,
right?
He said he was going to have my belt before we got to SummerSlam, and that hasn't taken place.
Let me show you what they're saying about you. I just want you to see. Here's Rick Rude and his manager, Bobby Heenan, talking about you.
The Brain.
Bobby
the Weasel.
Good.
Weasel.
No, Bobby knows
that an animal needs food to survive. Well, tonight, it's survival of the fittest. And Warrior, you're just going to be another link in the food chain of this hungry beast.
That's right, Ultimate Warrior. I have devoured you before. Now you will find out history must repeat itself. You are but a guppy in the ocean of life, and what you are about to find out is the waters in which you swim are inhabited by the deadliest predator of all, Ravishing Rick Rude, the next World Wrestling Federation champion.
Did you hear what he called you, a guppy in the ocean of life?
I cannot keep. Rick Rude has battled me all over the country, and I beat him 1, 2, 3 in a 15-foot steel cage at SummerSlam. I will take the rest of the strengths that he has and leave with those two. Rick Rude has less in his whole body than I have in my calf muscles alone. Rick Rude, I have no challenges to be nobody.
What is this? The big brush? Wait a minute.
We lost you.
Here's what I like. I like when you get mad, you know? When they come to you for the interview and you're like this. Wait a minute. No. What prompted that outburst?
He's just a little pussycat. He just got a little crazy.
That's all.
He's gonna be all right.
Calm down now.
Holy cow!
And I got Kathy Lee.
Sonny Grosso.
Yeah, for once the stagehands are gonna get some work done. We'll be right back with Sonny in a moment. A big hand for the Ultimate.
Right now, yeah.
Yes.
Ooh, ooh,
You know what Truthity is there? We can cut it with a knife. Yes. We hardly wait. We just, you're a part of it, a cold.
Absolutely, yes.
Oh, ring's plane ticket. Don't be distracted.
You're right okay, here, but the queen is walking around.
Oh, yeah, the queen is walking around. Yeah. Kathy Lee, what do you think?
I think the queen can walk anywhere she wants to.
We don't have to worry about Regis Philbin hitting me from behind against the warrior. You're going to be watching the queen right there.
And I love his sunglasses. The greatest glasses in the world.
Ooh, and they come off, too.
I see a few stitches there in your hand. What happened to you?
Well, you know, you just don't go into battle without getting some rewards. It can be a trophy-type situation, and I gave the Ultimate Warrior a big trophy at the Royal Rumble, and now he's the greatest World Wrestling Federation champion ever. Past, present, and future, yesterday, today, and tomorrow. What was that? A disturb... Well, go Warrior, go where? Ultimate Warrior's career down here, but and the Macho King.
What's your strategy, Macho King?
My plan is no plan. I'm the human torpedo. I give unrequested information all the time.
I see. So he doesn't know what you're going to do.
Let me tell you something. The Ultimate Warrior's got no chance at all. Comparatively speaking, the Ultimate Warrior's got the same chance as Alexis has got to get together with Blake.
Oh.
It's the dynasty of the Kingdom of the Madness that will prevail, and I will not falter.
You know what I say?
Yeah.
He's
sending the Macho King. We'll be back with our giant return.
Kathy Lee, Regis, shall we all sit down and relax?
6'10", I had no idea. 6'10".
Yeah. Let's sit down, guys.
How tall is he when he sits down?
6'11". Why don't we sit down?
Oh, he don't need to sit.
Oh, he doesn't need to sit.
No, he don't at all.
No. Are you ready to go tomorrow night, Undertaker?
What you fail to realize, Mr. Regis... This is not about winning and losing. This is life and death.
Really?
What did Hulk ever do to you?
Yeah.
What did he ever do to me?
Yeah.
He is a self-righteous pig.
Ooh.
Did he say pagan or pig?
Pig. He said pig.
And tomorrow.
And as y'all make fun, as you make games, this is life and death.
Who's making games?
Death. Death is our business.
Death is your business. I understand.
I know that.
And business is good.
And business is good.
And I saw a clip the other day when poor Hulk Hogan came out in your mortuary and was talking nice to you, and then suddenly something very dastardly happened to him. Take a look at this clip. We'll show you what has led up to this bout here. Watch this.
What are you going to do, Hulk Hogan, when Ric Flair runs wild on you? Let me tell you.
Now watch this, gang, because at any minute the Undertaker is going to come out.
WWF champion Hulk Hogan, you will find out, Ric Flair. Not only will the thousands of little Hulksters out there be at your beckoning call.
Now watch this.
Hulk Hogan will be right there, ready for you.
Stop! Now watch how he grabs Hulk with his hand.
That's a dirty shot.
And look at the Ric Flair jumping and stomping on the poor Hulk. Now watch this. Go! He's got poor Hulkamania by the throat, and he's not going to let him up, snuffing the life out of the Hulkster.
When was this, Reach?
This was just recently, just the other day, and so that's the background to this death versus life match tomorrow night.
It's going to be the first funeral on pay-per-view.
First funeral on pay-per-view. Well, that's a good one, Paul. That's a good one. I see you. Malcolm out wherever you are. You know what I got for you? I got this for you, baby. Right here. Yes. Come on. Come on, let go of that.
Is he crazy?
He's a little crazy, but he's cute.
Oh,
And finally, and finally... Yes, hold through. Oh, get him out of here. Get him out of here.
Friday on Live, one of England's most colorful entertainers, Dame Edna, and the one and only...
All right, it's this Sunday. Coming up, former World Wrestling Federation champion Macho Man Randy Savage will have a second chance at the title when he takes on the current champion Ric Flair, and there's more to this match than meets the eye. He's
there
hot,
always is.
He's furious, he's Macho Man. Here's Randy Savage.
Good to see you again.
How are you, Randy?
Yeah. Well, let me tell you about it, all right? Yeah, how long do you have?
Well,
the Fighting Irish of Notre Dame, I respect you big time. Yeah, you have pride. And the hysteria that Indiana has going against Duke in the NCAA, let it happen. Yeah, Bobby Knight cracking the whip. Everybody psyched up.
Yeah.
But.
Yes.
That is only one-millionth of the intensity that I am going to have when I walk down the aisle in the Hoosier Dome in Indiana.
Yes!
April the 5th, WrestleMania 8, when I do a tap dance on Ric Flair's head. The once and future World Wrestling Federation champion, I told you now.
Yes.
No problem.
All right.
May I
sit yes,
down?
Absolutely, Macho.
And you know, may I say, you smell good.
She's falling under your spell, Macho.
Beautiful. This isn't smell-o-vision, but that's, yeah, I like it. Aha! Uh-huh.
Which I usually don't expect, you know.
Why? I'd smell bad
before.
No,
you've always smelled very nice. We did the Variety Club Telethon together last year.
Exactly, for the kids.
For the kids, and you
for
won't
the
be
kids.
There this year because it's this Sunday and you're going to be at the Hoosier.
Exactly.
Yeah.
But if I could, have an out-of-body experience, I would be there. Yeah. I don't know that I can't do it. Maybe I'll show.
Maybe you'll show up anyway.
A cameo.
Maybe if you get rid of Ric Flair real quick,
real
you can come
quick.
On back.
Yeah. And
I'm
going to
take my time with Ric Flair.
Oh, you're going to torture him a little bit.
Wow, why not? Yeah, he's been torturing me.
He's been torturing you as
well. Torturing Elizabeth.
I know.
Trashing her name.
I know, Macho.
Through the mud. This is the 90s, yeah. You know, her mother and her grandmother and her grandfather, it hasn't been a real good time for them.
No, I'll
bet.
Very
distraught.
Yes. Very good.
My husband would do exactly what...
Well, sure.
I'll make it happen. All I have to do is let patience be a virtue. Okay?
All right.
Have patience, okay?
Patience.
But I'm not a doctor, so I don't have patience.
Doesn't it smell good? It
smells good, the Macho Man.
I'm not going to self-destruct right here.
No,
in
no.
The Regis and Kathy Lee
no,
show.
Don't
no,
don't lose it here.
Don't lose
heaven
it here.
Heaven forbid.
Now, listen, Macho.
Years ago, I would have, but with age comes wisdom sometimes.
Right.
And I'm 39 years young. Jimmy Connors did it, so I'm going to do it
Macho
this
Man.
Time. Yes!
Now let's take a look at Macho Man in action, and you'll see how valuable Elizabeth is to him. She's there, she's at his side.
She's the best!
The Macho Man going up to the high rope here. He's going to smother Hercules. Now watch this jump.
Air Nobody... traffic control, look out!
Ah, boom! Nobody does it like the Macho Man.
You've been a friend of mine. Look at
now look how beautiful
right
she
there.
Is, and she's so
she's
loyal.
She's a wonderful to you. Person. Let me tell
now
you
look,
that right
she
now.
Is.
She's my much better half. Oh, yeah! You did it before I did.
Yeah, now watch this.
Uh-huh. What happens here, Elizabeth?
Look out!
Wow!
Oh.
You know something? I thought Elizabeth put me on her shoulder, but no, that didn't happen then.
No, but there she is, Macho Man and his lady Elizabeth. But there's more going on than just meets the eye. We're going to come back and tell you about that in a
Love
moment.
Love that girl! Yeah!
He loves this woman.
Oh, yeah!
Now, there's a lot going on behind the scenes of this match, and part of it is because Ric Flair has opened his mouth about what happened years ago between him and Elizabeth. I don't know if it's true or not.
It's not!
All right, well, let's take a look at what happened on a recent WWF wrestling match. Mean Gene meeting Ric Flair and getting a lowdown on what really went on years ago.
Mean Gene wasn't...
Here we are. Look at this.
Wow, where was that?
At her dining room table. Dawn Perignon. She's really working on me here, you know. Look at the look in her eyes. Have you ever seen a woman more content in your entire life? And look at here at the stables.
Oh.
There she is with her two favorite studs.
Jeff, I guess you were her first mate, huh?
Yeah, something like that, Mr. Perfect. Damaged goods. Let's go back here. Oh. Remember I told you about the towels at the pool? The initials R&L, Rick and Liz. And look at here. She even remembered my favorite fruit, strawberries. Oh, cracking up, Savage. You having a hard time swallowing this?
Well, are you having a...
I think I hate that person.
Yeah, okay, let's give him an answer.
You want me to give him an answer?
I want you to give him an answer.
I'll give him an answer. What I'm going to do to Ric Flair, all right, is the same that you would do if somebody trashed Joy through the mud with untrue lies.
Pull his eyeball.
It's the same... That Frank Gifford would do for you, Kathy Lee, because I know Frank Gifford and I know what he's made of.
In a heartbeat.
That's exactly right. It's the same as Ahmad would do for Felicia. And it's the same as Donald Trump would do for Marla. Wait a minute. I might be wrong about that. He might buy the guy off. No, wait a minute. He might possibly can't do that at this exact time. Hey.
Well, you're going after this guy.
I'm going after this guy April the 5th, WrestleMania 8. Bet on me you could be a millionaire overnight because I'll guarantee you one thing. I'm the once and future World Wrestling Federation champion. Nobody does it better than the Macho Man Randy Savage. I'm going to do a tap dance on his head. Yeah. And I'm not going to put him away quick. I'm going to make him miserable. Yeah.
Make him suffer. Torture the way you him, have Macho. Suffered.
Isn't
that's
that
right.
Something? This is the 90s. Why not let it happen that way?
No mercy?
No mercy. Mercy, mercy, no mercy. No, not from the Macho Man Randy Savage.
All right.
The sky is the limit. Each and every person in this studio, you would do the same for your main squeeze. You would do the same for your girlfriend or your wife. Yeah. And there's zillions of people all around the world. You're going to say something right now.
I'm going to say, wait a minute. Ric Flair's not done yet. He's got something else to say to you right here.
Man, more salt in the wound.
Let's go for it right now.
You following this, Savage? Huh. It's a problem you have to live with the rest of your life. I'm Ric Flair. Elizabeth knows that, and you're not. That's something you gotta live with. Remember this, Savage. I'm gonna dump you. Just like I dumped her. You two deserve each other. Damaged goods. Live together the rest of your life. I'm Ric Flair, and I'm riding high. Woo!
Right? I have proof that he's a damn liar. Yeah, but that's okay, because let WrestleMania happen. Because this is a situation where it can be cleared up in time.
Time.
4 days away. The Hoosier Dome, 70,000 plus people. Hey, listen.
But these pictures are out. They cannot be withdrawn. They are out. They've been made.
Nobody ever said I was a rocket scientist.
All right.
Okay?
Well, now, wait a minute.
I don't know how we did it. But they never hit.
But in the newest edition of the WF magazine, there is still someone else besides Ric Flair. Who claims to have been with Elizabeth?
No.
Who has pictorial proof of this?
Is it you, Regis?
Well, look right over here. Look at me playing pool with.
You weasel.
It was before your time. You'll have to live with it. Let bygones be bygones. She was with me before you.
You know, Randy, they're able to do this technologically, you know? They do it at the National Enquirer all the time. They put people together that were never together. Right, Reach?
Macho, let's bygones be bygones. You go after Ric Flair. Leave me out of it. It was even before Ric Flair's time with him.
Unbelievable.
Reach! How do you think Joy feels right this instant?
Joy, I told Joy about it. Joy understands.
Well, let me have a private conference with Joy. I think I can make her believe something special.
Tuesday on Live, the beautiful Angie Dickinson. Tomorrow on Live, Dolly Parton and Claudia Cohen and the newest and hottest toys with Dick DiBartolo.
And it's always a pleasure to have them. Very few wrestlers can match the drama and style of our next guest. Even few can ever claim the championship belt. Let's take a look at what happened last week in Hershey Park, Pennsylvania. And there's Ric Flair. He's got Macho Man in a figure four leg lock. That's very painful, and that is incidentally how he wins the belt. Macho Man out cold. Ric Flair taking his bow. And here comes Mr. Perfect.
Wrestling Federation Champion, Ric!
Audience is booing, Reach. There's something going on here.
Audience is not. Audience didn't like that at all. Yeah, well. In any event, here he is. With his executive consultant, Mr. Perfect, here's the new champion, Ric Flair.
Hi, Ric. How are you?
Perfect. Hey, man, how are you?
Look how beautiful.
How are you?
Mr. Perfect is here.
Hello.
Yes. Have a seat.
Thank you.
For a minute, I thought the Donna Karan fashion show had started early. Wow, isn't that the most gorgeous thing you've ever seen?
What did Mr. Perfect just flick?
What did you do?
Gum? Mr. Perfect flicks gum when
he comes... Well, I didn't want to chew and talk at the same time.
Yeah.
Where is it? He flicked it into Robin Leach's pasta.
Probably do him some good.
Anyway, welcome, guys, to the show. Congratulations on the belt. And this is what it looks like right here.
They're not going
to
let you see that, really.
Oh, come on. Is that the most coveted belt in sports or not?
The one and only.
Yeah.
You've had it before, right? You had it before,
yes,
and you lost
my
it.
My second time with it.
Yeah. You went, when did you win it last?
I won in January.
Won in the lost in April.
Lost in April.
Lost it in April. And but Macho Man looked like he was out cold.
He was. That pain.
Did you
and
do
paying the price.
Did you do something to him before or during the match? Or?
Well, actually,
because the crowd was kind of booing Ric. I mean,
there
weren't
some booing.
Well, he's a fan favorite, and he's you know, very well received around the world. But
yeah.
It's a tough sport, and we play to win, and that's
So you don't care what the fans think.
Nope, I'm the dirtiest player in the game, day in and day out.
And proud of it.
Yeah. All right, now, okay. But here's really what happened. You heard what he said. We play to win. Yeah, they sure do. Here's what really happened just prior to Ric winning that belt. Here's a clip now. Look very carefully. It's just 10 seconds.
Mr. Perfect getting involved. Between the Macho Man and the Ultimate Warrior, taking the leg out of the Macho
Man. Sure, they threw him out of the ring. And now,
on the knee of Randy Savage.
That was Mr. Perfect, and that, and that's what they did. They worked on that knee.
We went after the weakness.
Now, what is your role with Ric?
I am the executive consultant to the real World Wrestling Federation champion, Ric Flair. I consult Ric Flair. We talk over strategies. We plan out our matches and our strategies. And what we did there with the Macho Man at SummerSlam.
Yeah.
Well, that was a buildup now. Knowing that he has that bad leg, Ric Flair had the title match with him in Hershey. It was like a cakewalk for us.
Be nice. Be nice.
Oh, she can get mean. Unfortunately, the title shot at SummerSlam was mine, but Jack Tunney, for some unknown reason, tried to slide me aside and put the Ultimate Warrior in the title shot. 83,000 people, London, England.
Yeah, went over real big.
I had to be there.
Now, last year, it seemed to me that there was a big flap about you and Elizabeth. We had Macho Man here. We showed him some pictures, those revealing photos you had. Tell me about that.
She's never returned. She's never gotten over it.
Really? But did you really have
you are a sweetheart.
I am?
Yeah.
Yeah.
You know all there is?
Yeah. Boy, yeah, you broke up their marriage? I mean,
well, no, actually, I
you
knew
caused
before
problems
they were married.
In
No, he knew her.
I know that, but showing him the pictures was very upsetting him. Could have broken up their marriage. Have you no shame? Have you no decency? Have
I guess, you could say Savage doesn't have a leg to stand on anymore.
These guys don't care. These are ruthless guys.
They don't care.
They really are. So where do we go from here? Are you going to defend your belt like a
I'm
real champion?
I'm defending the title against the Ultimate Warrior in weeks to come.
This Friday night, as a matter of fact, you're taking on The Undertaker.
That's right, Madison Square Garden.
Now, The Undertaker is about as tough. We had him out here one time. Look at this face. Look at this face.
The Undertaker is a real pussy cat.
That's Frank Gifford after 5 more years of marriage.
That was funny.
The Undertaker's a tough call.
Well, see,
Jack Tunney, the president of the World Wrestling Federation, signed this. This was a non-title match when you signed to wrestle The Undertaker in Madison Square Garden, unknowingly in Hershey, that Ric Flair was going to be the world champion. Now Jack Tunney turns around and makes it this Friday night a title match in Madison Square Garden. That doesn't sit well with me because I'm the consultant.
You are the consultant.
This is my business.
Well, he should be consulting with you, shouldn't he?
Yeah.
Well, so what happened? He overlooked you.
He went
over your head.
Yeah.
I don't like that. I don't like that at all.
I don't either.
Meanwhile, this poor guy wants another shot. Bad knee and all. Understand?
Ah.
Look how the crowd loves him.
There's nothing, the crowd loves
the macho man.
There's no feeling worse known to an athlete than the feeling of being a loser. And you're waking up the next day, being the next champion. Your husband will tell you that. When you've been on top and you've been the man, it's very hard to walk out that door and say, hey, I got beat.
Let me ask you guys a real personal question. Do you both go to the same hairstylist?
I was going to ask you two the same question.
We don't.
Who is the real blonde here?
Well, I am.
What?
No roots.
No roots.
God, he is a real blonde. What about you, Mr. Perfect?
You're not going to get close to me.
Go ahead, Reed. Mess up his hair. I want to see what he does.
But he is he really is. Look at these. See, other guys, look at that. I just have plain black things here. But
how about
this guy right here. How about
that.
The watch?
Yeah.
Big Rolex. Better watch out walking around New York with that.
Oh, who's going to take it off him?
You know, another big problem, you know, we're talking about a lot of things, but the Ultimate Warrior now is the number one contender.
Yeah.
And that's one of our major concerns here because the Ultimate Warrior is a former World Wrestling Federation champion as well.
That's right.
And he's got all the little warriors all over the country that back him and support him. We know in the future we're going to have our hands full, but with Mr. Perfect,
if he wants to keep on dancing, he'll walk the other way. You've seen him when he's
I've seen him with that Indian dance. Yeah, it's very effective.
Yeah.
It scares the heck out of a lot
of
people.
It's been effective in the past.
All right.
We really don't think it'll work with us.
But we got to get.
We're all business.
We're all business today. We've got the executive consultant. We got to get past the Undertaker Friday night at the Garden, right? And then we'll get on with the Ultimate Warrior. Thanks so much, Mr. Perfect.
My pleasure. You're a
good guy. Very good to see you, buddy. So
nice to meet you.
See, perfect gentleman, these guys.
Double
woo! One more time.
Woo!
I love it. We'll be right back with Donna Karen.
Tomorrow on Live, our very own Fabio returns with his very own calendar.
Oh, wait a minute.
This guy stands out in a crowd.
Absolutely. Did anybody recognize Macho Man Randy Savage? Yeah, yeah.
Ooh, yeah, Motown. Dig it.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. You're going into the Survivor Series in Richland, Ohio.
This is my Survivor Series get down outfit right here.
Yeah.
I want to enter that fashion show later on.
Yeah,
you know what I'm saying?
Yes.
Cindy Crawford, watch out. Taking over, yeah.
Yeah. Doesn't he look good?
He looks fantastic. Randy, how's Miss Elizabeth doing?
Well, bottom line is we got a divorce.
No.
Yes, you're right. Yep.
No.
Super serious, one of those things that didn't work out, nobody's to blame, and I just want to say that in my heart, I'll always love her.
Well,
so sad to hear this
news. Gee, I'm sorry to hear this. Surely Eater and Macho Man are going together now. I'm
stunned.
We're stunned.
I have no
idea. I'm very sorry. She's a lovely lady, but I'm grateful that it's amicable.
Very lovely lady.
Yes. All right, Macho Man. Well, you're going to come back and be a part of our Macho Men of Michigan fashion show, right?
Not only that, but I'm going to win it.
All right. Ah, Macho Man, thank you for...
Thanks, Randy.
Well,
thank you.
It's one scoop after another around here.
I have to say thanks to Susie, Zach, and... Stephanie Kasapis, because they really helped out with all the makeup and hair and really did a good job.
Okey-doke.
Our next athlete, are you ready, folks, is the wild and wacky Macho Man Randy Savage. This world wrestling champ is known for his outrageous get-ups on stage, but does he dress as dramatically when not wrestling? Let's take a look.
Yeah! That's his understated elegant look.
Yes. That's something I like to have.
Looking good, Randy.
Oh, yeah. You could see what I see right now. Kathy Lee, Regis, check Kathy Lee out right now.
You know, chartreuse is your color.
X-ray vision.
Yeah.
She looks good today. Yeah.
You put these glasses on and everybody's clothes are off.
Uh-huh.
Very good. Okay, Randy, strut down that aisle.
Stop, Randy.
Show what you got.
So sad about him and Miss Elizabeth. Very upset about that, Kehlani.
Survivor Series coming up November 25th, Richland, Ohio. Thank you,
be
Randy.
Be there. Be square, Reach.
And good luck.
And our final...
All right, tonight's the night. The WWF having their annual SummerSlam. It's being held in the Palace of Auburn Hills right outside of Detroit. Yeah, it's on pay-per-view tonight. And we're going to bring out now the World Wrestling Champion. He's a 500-pound former sumo wrestler who has taken the World Wrestling Federation by storm. Here he is in action, Yoko.
Why would somebody want to go in the ring with him?
But the thing is, he does it with a smile, doesn't he? All right, here he is, Yokozuna, and his advisor, Jim Cornette.
Jim, I thought it... Yoko, I'm so sorry. Would you like me to sit? Thank you very much.
All right.
Can't even get good furniture.
Welcome
hello, Regis. I'm so excited. Hello,
Yoko. Welcome to the show. Good luck tonight.
How are you?
We had Lex Luger here, you know.
That's why we demanded equal time, because everybody might have thought Lex Luger came out here, the guy that Yokozuna is wrestling tonight at SummerSlam live on pay-per-view. He came out here, and I know everybody was real taken with him, but you see, Yokozuna, I know Luger's got a big body, and he's all muscular, good-looking guy. Yokozuna is ruggedly handsome.
Yeah.
You understand what I'm saying?
Yes.
He is ruggedly handsome. He gets a lot of fan mail and a lot of love letters from a lot of... In fact, Christina, we have answered yours. It's in the mail.
Time out. Why are you wearing this around your neck?
I got up off my deathbed to come out here today. I got dropped on my head in Knoxville, Tennessee about 10 days ago, but I got up off my deathbed. I couldn't miss a chance to see Regis, because the way you dress, Regis, the way you conduct yourself, you'd make a great wrestling manager, and I want to talk to you about some lessons for a low price, because they pay him a lot to do this show. For a low price, I'd be glad to study under me. I may take you up on that.
May I ask you a question?
You might not get an answer, but you can ask it.
This belt that he has on his shoulder, is that the championship?
That is the World Wrestling Federation championship belt. That's what's on the line here. Would you like to fondle? I'd like to see if this fits.
Oh, it's heavy.
Oh, it might go around Regis.
It might become
part of a jewelry collection.
Loosen the other home shopping network soon.
Don't walk too far, Regis. He gets nervous if it goes more than 3 feet.
Wow. Tell me about Yokozuna.
I'm so excited tonight because at SummerSlam, Yokozuna's been the World Wrestling Federation champion for quite some time now. He faces his toughest test against Lex Luger.
I wouldn't do that if I were you. Don't do that.
What? What's the matter? Dr. Kevorkian was booked this week? You want to take the army? But anyway, Yokozuna,
now, how do you advise him?
Yokozuna is a champion. I'm the official English language spokesperson because, you know, Mr. Fuji, who is the manager of Yokozuna, as a matter of fact, he's right now at the airport getting our Learjet all gassed up, ready to go to Detroit. He simply hired me to interpret some of the contracts because there's not a lot of English words that I haven't heard or used.
Yes, but how does he converse with you?
Does he speak English? He doesn't have to say anything to me
because Mr. Fuji does all that, and Yokozuna just gets in the ring and tears people bit from bit. And tonight at SummerSlam, Lex Luger, you know, he's been doing a call to action campaign where he's ridden a bus all across America. As a matter of fact, he ought to get a friend named Norton, and he'd be perfect because then they could redo the honeymooner.
Yeah, that's right.
But I'll tell you something right now. Yokozuna, while Lex Luger's been riding the bus, Yokozuna's been training. He's been eating at a buffet 16 times
a day. What does he eat?
600. Hey, I'll tell you what. We went to a restaurant. Mr. Fuji ordered. Mr. Fuji ordered a steak medium rare. I ordered a steak well done.
Okay.
Yokozuna said, knock the horns off, bring it out on a leash. He'll eat anything.
Let's take a look. No, wait, I got to show this one clip, okay?
Let's see it.
Here's Yokozuna in action. You got to see this, all right? Here we go. Go. Now watch this. He spins the guy across. Now, here he comes. Here comes Yokozuna.
Future tonight.
Now watch what Yoko does here. No. He's not going to climb up those ropes, Jim.
Yes.
Wait, pull the man down.
Ladies and gentlemen, the bonsai drop.
No bonsai.
And believe it.
Yokozuna. We'll be right back. We're going to have a tug of war with Yokozuna in just a moment.
Tuesday on Live, actor Tony Danza.
I'm explain to Yokozuna, we're going to have a tug of war
here. Yeah, would you not sit on Regent? Yeah.
No, we don't do that. Don't throw away, tug of war.
Pick up El Ropo.
We do not sit on anybody.
Wait a minute, that's Spanish.
Well, whatever it is.
Okay, Yoko. As a matter of fact, he don't have to tug because it's going to be you, right? He doesn't have to tug, you just hold it.
No, there's going to be, but let's see what happens. Get up.
That's not here just you.
Yoko,
where's he going?
El Ropo.
Okay. We're going to die, Regent.
Doesn't he take it up?
Okay. The yellow ribbon.
All right, whoever the yellow ribbon from.
Yellow ribbon. Wait, if this yellow ribbon comes across.
Okay, wait a minute. All right, go.
Nobody said
wait
go.
Wait a minute. We didn't say go. I've never. All right, ready, and go. One hand. Okay.
All right, wait. Gelman, get over here.
Lex Luger and Regis Philbin.
All right. Wait a minute.
Hey.
All right, ready, guys? You ready? We just quit pulling. I didn't say go yet.
Okay.
All right, ready? Go.
Are you pulling, Gil?
We're just playing with you. Morgan?
Okay.
All right. Tommy, come on in. Tommy.
Wait a minute. No, just a minute.
No?
Wait a minute.
Come here.
What is this? What is this? How many people are you going to get here now?
My Cardell Hayes kid right here. Come on.
Okay.
What's your name, pal?
Brian. Okay, ready? Go! For this carpeting, great idea.
I'm fixing to lodge a protest here.
Let's pull this carpeting back.
Okay,
I don't
pull
get
it back.
Pull it back, Tommy.
There we go.
Okay. You can do it.
Here we go.
All
we got to do is get that yellow ribbon across.
Using one arm, I want you to know. Just one arm. Okay. Ready? Go.
Good luck, Yokozuna. Tonight, pay-per-view. All right, thank you, Yokozuna. You're still the greatest. Tomorrow, an all-new show, Garth Brooks and Lou Rawls and Patty Weaver.
Looking forward to it.
And Adrian Uphill. Bye-bye, everybody.
Have a great day, everybody. Bye-bye.
Wrestling. Who's going to take Hulk Hogan's place? Who's going to bring wrestling up to the forefront again? Here he is.
All right. Now, come on. You know and I know there could be a possible return to the ring, Hulkster. Give us the latest on this.
Yeah, let us know.
We want Hulk.
We want Hawk. We want Hawk.
Let's hear it.
Oh, boy.
Come on, Hulk. All right, Hulk's ready to talk.
Well, you know something, brother. I was in the airport last night. And when I was flying here to see Regis, a little old lady came up to me. She goes, Hulk Hogan, you make me feel 18 years old again. You know, the lady said, I quit watching wrestling when you were on there. You were the greatest there ever was, greatest there ever will be. And it's not the same without you. And you know something? I've been thinking about coming back. For all the right reasons, you know. For all the right reasons, because I miss it so much.
Sure.
I love the sport. And my son, Nicholas, and my daughter, Brooke,
yeah,
they keep saying, Dad, when are you going to get in the ring again?
Yeah.
So I've been talking with a few different promotions, and there's a possibility.
All right.
No kidding.
Yeah.
Now, is this a solo, or would you have, like, a tag team partner, or?
Well, of course, I have Jimmy Hart with me.
Oh, Jimmy Hart. I love him. He's a great manager, Jimmy. The Mouth of the South. The best.
So I'm getting in shape, and the TV series is right now the priority, and as soon as that's done, I'm going to make an announcement in the next couple weeks. It's going to knock the whole wrestling world on its heels.
The Hulk, I think, is coming back. He's ready for it. You're ready for it, Hulk.
I'm ready.
Do you have to, because I've seen you bigger.
Yeah,
do you have
to
get bigger?
You've seen Hulk bigger than
I've
this?
I've seen him, yes.
Tonight he defends his heavyweight championship, and he's managed, incidentally, by another wrestling favorite. Let's meet him first. Here's Shawn Michaels, everybody.
Before we even start this, I know all the World Wrestling Federation superstars come out here and they talk to you.
Yeah.
But I'd like to talk to Miss Gifford here for a second.
Yeah, sure.
Because I know she's had a little trouble with some of the superstars
in the past.
And where I come from down south, although I don't appear to be one, I am a southern gentleman. And where we come from, a woman like you is easy on the eyes, and it is a pleasure to be out here with you.
Thank you very much, Mr.
Michael.
Very much.
Yay. Get out, Sean.
Certainly.
Let's go to lunch, but you'll have to change.
No problem.
Kathy just said, let's go to lunch, but you'll have to change.
You don't know how tough it is.
That's funny.
You don't know how tough it is getting into a restaurant around here like this.
Well, you know, they're not let you into the circ, honey, I'm telling you.
I love your outfit. I really do. It's just color coordinated. You're a zebra. There's no doubt about it.
Well, I like to stay low-key. I'm that kind of guy.
What do I see here? World tag team? Did you guys win that again?
Well, I don't want to come out here and brag, but as a matter of fact, last night in Indianapolis, Big Daddy Cool Diesel and myself, fortunately, are now the new World Wrestling Federation Tag Team.
Oh, come on! Let's hear it! The tag team
is new!
This is new! Absolutely. All right. So let's bring the big guy out here, and you're managing him tonight.
That's right. Right. SummerSlam, United Center, Chi-Town.
All right, here we go. Here's Diesel. 7 foot, 370 pounds. Now. John, how big is your guy?
He is 7 foot, 330 pounds, and I'm telling you, he is a wrestling machine.
Really?
Not to mention the second biggest lady killer in the World Wrestling
Federation. Oh, my gosh. Let's take a break. We'll come right back and learn about more about Diesel. John Michaels.
All right. From the WWF, Shawn Michaels and Diesel. Last night, they won the tag team championship in Indianapolis against the Head Shrinkers, who are pretty tough cookies.
We've had the Head Shrinkers.
Yeah, Afa and the Head Shrinkers. Yeah.
It's a little fishy, though, don't you? Did you notice that?
Gosh, I'll never forget that.
A little weird. Still on the belts. We're thinking about having these steam things.
Yeah, we're going to have these steam things.
Now, I've never been to one of the actual fights, matches, whatever, but I've obviously seen all the footage. I've never, when you guys have come on, never seen a bruise. I've never seen a cut. I've seen a couple of bitten down nails. That's it. Not even a rope burn.
You got a black eye right now.
You look gorgeous.
Makeup took care of it. Thank you. Makeup took care of it.
He looks gorgeous.
He does. He looks very handsome. During the break, I was asking them, because after all, they are human beings. I was asking them about their personal lives and how difficult is it to maintain relationships because you guys are on the road 300 days out of the year.
Well, thankfully for me, I'm a single man, so I handle a lot of relationships. But, Big Daddy Cool here, why don't you feel that?
Yeah, I'm a married man, and it's hard on us to the point where it's such a stretch being out every day. You know, it's the only communication is the telephone,
yeah.
And you're gone maybe 2-3 weeks at a time. But I've got a good one.
Yeah,
she's a strong woman.
Yeah, definitely does.
6 years you've been married now?
6 years, yeah.
You have any children?
No, not yet.
See, that would be awfully hard, wouldn't it, to be away from
your... Well, this schedule's impossible to have children.
Yeah, he doesn't have kids.
My nose is trying, though.
I'm trying.
He doesn't even have an earring. And talk about earrings.
Well,
come on, look at this.
I got the market on the earrings, so...
Wow, you sure do.
Now, you take them off when you're wrestling, wouldn't you? That could hurt.
I have to, or else my opponents take them out.
So what's your strategy for Razor Ramon tonight at the big Summer Slam?
1-2-3 jackknife, he loses.
That's it. He's down, he's
absolutely
out.
But that'll
take
be too quick. Your fans want more.
Well, you know what? He's got Walter Payton.
And Walter Payton's managing him.
Now, I don't know if all these young ladies out here.
Precious Sweetness?
Yes.
Sweetness, exactly.
Chicago,
former running back, Hall of
Chicago
Famer.
Bears.
And he's there to keep his eye on me. Like, I'm going to do something. You know me, Reed. Come on.
Don't mess with Precious Sweetness.
I don't need any help.
Yeah.
Big Daddy Cool needs no help.
You're going to stay out of the ring tonight. You're just going to manage him.
You never know what's
going to happen. You never know what's going to happen. That's right.
Peyton sticks his nose in. Sean will be there for
me. If Peyton dares to get in that ring.
Absolutely. Oh, boy, better watch.
I think she's related.
How did she get in?
Yeah, but she could be related. Maybe even married to the eeriest person ever to step into the WWF ring. Here, if you dare, ladies and gentlemen, The Undertaker and his manager, Paul Bearer. Nice to see you again, Kathy
Lee. Mr. Undertaker, good to see you.
Yes, have a seat, guys. And, of course, we've got the urn here. Nobody really knows what's inside the urn, right?
That's right. It's been a long time secret.
But there are some mystical powers when the Undertaker is down and not doing so well. You sometimes hold the urn up to his face and give him the strength to overcome his adversary.
The power of the Undertaker is inside the urn.
Shall we... Now that's a substantial mustache. Have a seat, Paul.
Maybe LaLucci could do a love scene with you.
Yes. Undertaker's got his
Maybe
hands
not.
Full. He's got a big match coming up with Yokozuna, who has also been on our show. This is what they call...
Not related to Yoko Ono.
No.
Yokozuna.
No relation at all. Yokozuna, you've seen him on the show. Great big guy.
Now he's a big boy.
He goes over 500 pounds, and this is called the casket match, right?
Oh, yes. The WWF Championship versus the casket. The loser goes in the casket, Regis.
And
the winner walks away with the WWF title.
Oh, my God.
So I guess it's a big deal.
It's a very big deal, and I'd like to have a little more respect from you. This is a big deal. And there is the casket. You're looking at it right here. Now, whoever gets... What are they? Are you going to pick up Yokozuna if he's the loser and put him in there?
We'll just roll him in if we have to.
And how are you, Undertaker?
Fine.
Oh, good.
She's mad at me.
Why is he mad at you? Have you said something?
I'm having a better hair day than he is.
Don't upset me.
I don't know. The things that make people go crazy today, I don't know. I can't relate.
Oh, my.
And who does your makeup, by the way?
You better get a good night's sleep. You're beginning to look like a raccoon that I found outside my door. It's nice to have you guys here again.
Oh, sure.
Now, Undertaker, what is your favorite hold? What is the hold that you apply to when you're finishing off your opponent? What is that called?
For the tombstone pile driver.
The tombstone pile driver.
Pile driver?
Yes.
Pile driver.
I think we have a clip of that, and you'll see what we're talking about here. What the Undertaker does when he's finished with his opponent and how he totally destroys them. Here we go.
What's going through Yokozuna's mind? Besides fear. With a great agility from this huge...
All right, here it comes, Undertaker.
...mysterious individual that seemingly cannot be hurt.
The tombstone pile driver coming up.
Oh my gosh, not on his head.
Yes.
Oh my God.
Domino time.
for Derek. And The Undertaker
he's
has
finished.
Won this one.
Isn't that the rules?
No, that's part of the rules.
And we may have
and that's what you have planned for Yokozuna.
First of all, how is he going to pick up Yokozuna and turn him around like that? This is 550 pounds.
How tall is Yokozuna?
Undertaker is very strong, Regis.
Yeah.
Especially with that urn to help him.
Yes, the magic urn. He was the champion at one time, wasn't he?
Oh, yes. He beat Hulk Hogan. Everybody remembers that.
And then who took the title away from him?
Oh, Ric Flair.
Oh, Ric Flair.
That wimp?
Yeah. How could he beat
that?
That
doesn't seem possible.
The urn must have been missing
it
that night.
It wasn't possible. It was an accident. He used a chair and several other foreign objects, of course.
That's not allowed, is it? Are there rules?
There's rules.
Yeah. Well, let's take a look at this coffin, okay? See what this is
like. Go ahead, Reach.
No, let's just see. Boy, it's kind of heavy.
It's triple wide, triple deep. Yes.
Oh, yeah, this
just
is...
for Yokozuna.
You know, I've never really been inside one of these.
Oh, really? Fly it out,
and look what's in here.
Yes. Yes. So comfortable. Yes.
Here's something for Rova to play with. Okay, so what's this like? There's a lot of room in here.
You want to find out what it's like?
Hey, don't close it. Don't close it.
No. No, yes. Find your new partner, Jeffy Lane. He's gone now.
No, let me
out. Yokozuna, you got it.
Jeffy.
Oh, yes.
Jeffy, help me.
Yes.
Jeffy,
yes.
Help me.
No. No.
That is the latest World Wrestling Federation champion. I guess maybe he even won the title in that particular match.
He but looked he is... like he was about to, didn't he?
Sure did. 7 feet tall.
Uh-huh.
You like him big? 7 feet? Is that enough man for you? 317 pounds, and they call him Diesel.
Right.
Diesel came here, oozed a lot of charm all over Kathy
Lee. He was such a gentleman last time.
Yeah,
yeah, I was confusing you with one of those guys that, you know, leaves body fluids everywhere, you know. You're not one of those. You're a gentleman. You smell good, unlike the others.
Until he starts wrestling, then it don't smell too good. That is the belt, the Diesel?
This is it.
Yeah, good now, how long have you held this championship?
November the 26th.
November the 26th, and who did you defeat to?
Bob Backlund. I think it was
Bob Backlund, yeah. Oh, absolutely.
Was that the guy?
Yeah, I think so. I didn't see
that's
the trail.
That's a heavy, heavy belt.
He dropped him on his back. It was really rude.
Maybe he asked for it.
Now we're going up against Hitman Hart, huh?
Right.
Sunday night or Saturday night?
Sunday night,
Sunday
the 22nd.
Night. Where will that be?
In Tampa, Florida, on pay-per-view.
It's a pay-per-view.
Ah.
And the guest host this year is?
Pamela Anderson.
Now, see, that's my kind of an opponent. I don't need Hitman Hart. Just give me Pamela Anderson. She's beautiful.
Work it out.
Absolutely. You played some softball against her, didn't you?
Yeah, I was at the MTV Rocks and Jack softball game last Saturday.
Oh, that's right, yeah.
She was on the opposing team.
That's going to be aired, I think, in April.
Right.
Yeah.
I think it's a couple days from, yeah.
So tell me something. Were you always a wrestler? What did you do before wrestling?
I played some basketball.
Surprise.
College?
Yeah. Played in college, University of Tennessee. Played a little bit in Europe for a couple of years. Did a stint in the service for 2 years.
Mm-hmm.
What else did I do?
Didn't we talk last time you were here about missing your family on the road?
I've got a wife.
Yeah.
Yeah. That's my family.
Why don't you say it like this? I got a woman.
No, he happens to be very much in love with his wife.
How do you know that?
This is my Diesel. We have long talked.
Speaking of, I spent Wednesday, I was with Love Machine at the NFL 75th dinner.
Yes.
Yeah, I was there for that.
How did Love Machine look?
He looked good. Dennis Hopper did a little tribute to him, I think. Pretty respected man among the his peers there.
Yeah,
oh, not only that, but apparently Diana Ross. I'm dying to see this next week. Diana Ross sang at the end of it and picked Frank out of the crowd to do a little
What? See, I leave town for one day, and Diana tries to steal my man. We'll see. Do you see that?
Yes.
Was it as hot as I heard?
Frank was a good boy.
Because it's on TV, and I'll kill him.
So, Diesel, after the service, you were a bouncer, too, right?
Yeah, for about 4 years.
Did you ever have to really bounce somebody?
Oh, yeah, of course. Yeah.
Boing, boing, yeah. Boing.
I earned my money.
What, was that tougher than wrestling?
No.
Some nights?
No, the travel alone makes this a tough job.
Yeah.
Oh, absolutely.
Diesel gets tired.
Yeah. I probably look it. I've been on the run for about 30 days now.
Mm-hmm.
But you're young, Diesel. Doesn't
so
show.
When did you join the WWF?
2 years ago.
Uh-huh. And you had to work your way up, right?
Yeah, absolutely.
Have you had your share of injuries?
I mean, a busted nose, busted ribs, fingers.
But the ribs are a killer. Mine still hurts. Oh, that's a murder.
Is there any way to train for drops like that and punches like that? And how do you, I mean, when you know you're going to be dropped on your back, is there anything you can do physically to keep you from breaking your
relax
back?
Relax and enjoy it.
Quick prayer, maybe?
Really? There's not a whole lot you can do?
No, absolutely not.
What is your patent hole?
I think they showed it was the jackknife where I put somebody between my legs and hoist them up and throw them on their back.
Oh,
that's the one you did, yeah.
Oh, you want one?
No. No,
I think
Diesel.
She does. Yeah. Oh,
that was my PR person over there.
Yeah, Diesel, look at this picture of you. And is that Sean?
Is
that's Sean, yeah.
Now, here you are with our little perfect.
Looks like Dr. Ruth in here.
At a WWF function in the Poconos,
right.
I guess, huh?
Absolutely.
So now you're going to win Sunday night?
I think so.
Yeah? Have you ever wrestled Hitman?
Two other times.
And how'd you do it?
First time it was basically, it was interference. And the last time was King of the Ring, which was in July. And once again, interference. So.
But doesn't
so we don't
your,
know.
Doesn't
we don't
your
know.
Height and reach give you a terrific advantage over these guys? Because
yeah.
Hitman is probably 6'1", something 6'2",
right.
Something like that.
Leverage-wise, it does. But, you know, I give up in quickness what I have in strength, you know. So
mm-hmm. Equalize.
It's kind of a trade-off.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. So you're a happy Diesel.
Yeah,
He's a tired Diesel.
But a happy Diesel.
But a happy Diesel. All right, so you better get ready now. It's coming up 7 o'clock this Sunday, the Royal Rumble. On your TV set, pay-per-view, right?
Absolutely.
Diesel, thanks so much for coming by. Good to have you.
Nice to see you.
Diesel, you are a
nice guy.
Lawrence Fishburne, coming up next.
I brought you a hockey jersey from my hockey
Brett,
team.
Brett, I'm Joy. Nice
Hi,
to
Joy.
Meet you. How
yeah,
are you?
Yeah, how you doing? What is that?
It's a hockey jersey from my team.
From your team up in
Calgary,
Canada.
Yes.
Yeah, my you own a hockey team.
Yes.
Well, good for you. Are they in the NHL?
In the Western Canada Junior Hockey League.
Good. That's great. How does it feel to be an owner, an impresario?
It's been a great feeling.
That's good.
It's a very Canadian thing to do.
Sure. Are you a hockey player as well?
No, I'm a wrestler.
You're a wrestler. How long have you been wrestling, Brett?
Almost 17 years.
And your dad was a wrestler before you?
Yes, this is my dad here on my shirt.
Oh, is that right?
Yeah, did he
teach
you
how to wrestle?
He had a special
tribute to him. Yeah, basically.
Mm-hmm.
Basically, I've been watching wrestling or been part of wrestling since I was in diapers, I think. So.
Yeah, absolutely.
So he must be
it's thrilled. Your life, in other words.
Yes.
And now you are the champion of the WWF.
Third time. Best there is, best there was, and the best there ever will be.
Now, how do you prepare for a match like the one coming up on Sunday?
Well, the match I have this Sunday is it's a much more harder match than normal. It's a 60-minute match. It's most falls in the hour time limit. Most falls are submissions.
Mm-hmm.
So normally that match would be very, very difficult on any given night, but the fact that it's a pay-per-view and the fact that it's WrestleMania, which is like the biggest event for wrestling anywhere in the world, it puts a real extra added amount of pressure on me, and the fact that I'm wrestling a guy that sort of wrestles like a tennis ball.
What do you mean by that?
Right.
Coming back and forth?
Well, he's basically been taught by a Mexican, he's been taught by a Mexican wrestler from years ago who's taught him a lot of high-flying, fast, real motion kind of wrestling.
Yeah.
And wrestling him is just like wrestling a tennis ball. In contrast to me, where my father taught me wrestling,
where you
mostly,
grab the guy and hang on
yeah,
and get him
grab
down.
Grab him, yeah. Take him down, and make him cry out in pain.
Who does your costumes?
I have some girls in Chicago that do it.
And they made on your order? I mean, do you have...
Yeah, I have a lot to do. I design my, most of
you
my own outfits.
You design your own stuff. How intriguing, Brett.
And who named you Hitman, Brett? Did you name yourself
Well, I've never
Hitman?
Been sure whether they call me Hitman because I hit them all the time or whether it's because they hit me all the time. You know?
You're going to show
you
me...
Find out.
You're going to show me the moves that is going to take to win this championship?
I'm going to show you what... Yeah. I'm going to show Regis the moves. Here, take it.
That's right. See, he knows. We'll be right back. I got to work him over here.
Friday on Live, actor Tom Arnold.
Show me the best thing you
but
got.
But just for fun.
Yeah.
Just for fun.
Let me see. Let me see what you got.
I'll show you the sharpshooter.
Yeah. Oh, sharpshooter.
Watch his back.
You got to go down. You've already
on
been,
my knees?
You've already been beaten into submission.
Okay, I'm down like that.
Okay, now I got to...
This feels pretty good.
All right, you got
easy. Easy.
You got to lie on your back.
On my back.
Just ask him; he'll do it.
Okay, my sharpshooter. This
hey!
Is what's.
Hey!
Now don't hurt him, Brett.
Hey! Freaking finale! Get down here.
Okay, hold on, hold on. You're gonna roll this way. You've been beaten into submission.
Ah, yeah!
Oh my God.
And I can sit back.
You know, that looks painful. Is that painful?
No, that wasn't painful. Holy cow.
You want a little more?
Yeah, I want a little more.
Okay, then there's
I the, never get enough of this stuff.
There's the cross-faced chicken wing.
Cross-faced chicken wing. Go ahead, do it to me,
Regis,
baby.
Regis, take care.
I'm getting to like it.
Anyway, how's that?
Suppose I do this. Oh, the Hitman goes after Shawn Michaels this Sunday, WrestleMania, out there in Anaheim, and we'll be right back. Hitman, thank you.
Sehen wir nochmal Kevin Kelly. Also er ist uns nochmal zugeschaltet worden. Er hat Shawn Michaels da, aber wir werfen nochmal einen Blick zurück auf diese Talkshow The With Regis and Kathy Lee heißt sie. Und da sind regelmäßig World Wrestling Federation Superstars zu Gast. So in diesem Fall auch Shawn Michaels. Schauen wir uns das Ganze einfach mal so im O-Ton an. Können wir nochmal drauf eingehen danach.
Hi John, how you doing, big guy?
Wonderful, thank you.
I've been to those wrestling matches. The women go crazy over you. You're the heartthrob of the WWE. You're the heartbreak kid.
Well, yeah, that's what I'm in my gear, but not today. I'm just Shawn mostly.
Well, maybe that's because he gets his heart broken more than he breaks other people.
And that's the truth, too.
Oh, please.
Hey, it's true.
Oh, please, the
Tell
two
him,
of you.
Explain. It's true.
Who,
it is.
Who broke your heart last?
Everybody. Last girl I went out with.
Really?
And you know what? She's
she didn't want to wrestle?
Well...
Hey, Sunday night you got a big one, huh?
Yes.
Fighting Sid.
And,
well, what's your strategy against a big guy like that, Sean?
Run. Are you in? Run as fast as
run
I can.
Run between his legs a lot, surprise
exactly.
him from behind.
Yeah. Right. Run around a lot until he gets tired and kick him in the chin and call it a night.
But he's your... All right, there you go. The Survivor Series goes on. Here it is, Sean. Wear it well.
Thank you very much.
And good luck to you.
Say hello to young mama.
I will. Thank you so much.
He loves his mom.
I love
He's one of the greatest opponents. There he is, Lex Luger. This Sunday, he teams up with the Giant, whom I think we've had on the show in the past.
Yeah, who could forget?
They're going to challenge Hulk Hogan, who is pairing up with Dennis Rodman. Can you believe this?
I don't think I want to see that, Reach.
This is on pay-per-view. It's called Bash at the Beach. And here's Lex Luger.
All righty then.
Lex,
how are you, Lex? Nice to see you. I mean, you got Regis's body. What's the problem?
Identical twins.
Identical twins.
He's got your hair and my body.
Gee, thanks, Regis.
So, I've admired you for a long time, really. You're the best built guy in all of wrestling.
Thank you.
Absolutely.
With a Should great... I leave you two alone?
With great abs, which I hope we're going to see in a little bit, and a great pair of
guns. That's what
they call
fighting.
That's the first time I heard that. Yeah. That's what. Why do you call these guns?
Because they jump out and bite you if you... Good guns. You used to play pro football.
Heard that?
Yeah? Yes. Yeah? Who'd you play for?
Green Bay Packers.
Green Bay Packers. Yeah, so what position did you play?
Oh, I was an offensive guard.
Offensive guard? Yeah. You must have slimmed down since...
Yeah, I've lost about 30 pounds since I played football.
Yeah, good. Yep. So you are going for the championship now, right?
Well, actually, we were involved in Dennis Rodman's wrestling debut this upcoming Sunday.
This is his debut?
Yeah. He's been around a little bit, but he hasn't actually gotten in the ring. So the Giant are anxious to pin him down and actually get him in the ring.
I remember when Lawrence Taylor did it. Is this the second time that somebody from another major sport has come?
Yeah, a lot of the athletes. Reggie White was at the last pay-per-view, and he wrestled. And a lot of guys have dabbed a little bit, but Dennis Rodman's definitely a different story. I'm anxious to see if he can wrestle.
Yeah,
I just wonder
what color hair he's going to have.
Yeah, we know he can do his hair and makeup and accessories, and we know he can dress.
Will that be part of his whole strategy to sort of psych you out?
I hope he doesn't wear a dress to the ring.
What if he wears the wedding dress? What are you going to do?
Yeah, you can't slam a bride like
that.
You
got that torture rack.
Well, what about here's what I want you to do for us. Put Dennis on the torture rack.
I'd like to. Trust me.
What is the torture rack? How exactly does that work?
It's kind of hard to describe, but I...
Can you show him?
No, I actually can't. I mean,
why is that? Are you afraid you're going to hurt me?
Yeah, actually I am,
Oh, go ahead.
I'm really curious. I'd love to see it. Can't you just...
I picked the guy up across my shoulders, and that's actually a... submission hold.
Yeah, you spin him around?
You have to see, I guess.
Oh, we all know those.
Yeah. Okay, mm-hmm. Fine. You want to show us your abs?
Yeah, I guess.
That's the one part of my body that I haven't perfected. My abs, I can't make them jump out anymore.
We'll work on that today.
Well, we'll just see.
Well, I'll hold you.
When we come back, we're going to show you the abs. Okay? This is kind of weird to have a man show you his body, but this guy does have great abs. And he's standing right behind me right now.
There's a lot of sexual tension between the two of you. There really is.
So if you're ready, here's Lex Luger, WCW. Show him, Lex. Again, Cody. All right, we all want to look like you.
But how?
I don't know.
I really hate it when a man has bigger breasts than I've got. That really.
I think even Kathy Lee wants to look like you.
Yeah, I do. But how long did it take you to look like that? You must have been obsessed.
A long time. Through busy training for football and all the way through into wrestling.
Yeah.
I've been training a long time. It's a combination. I do a lot of cross training. I do weight training, some type of progressive resistance training, along with a lot of aerobic training.
Mm-hmm.
You know,
and you show us Stairmasters,
and I'd also do a lot of flexibility training. So it's
okay. You cannot expect to look like this unless you put in a lifetime of working at it. But you can start.
No, but there's a lot of simple things. I stick to fundamentals and basics. And when it comes to abdominal training, of course, a lot is hooked into your diet. And I stress to people, you don't need equipment. I travel all the time on airplanes. You guys do too. Mm-hmm. And whether I'm in a rental car or in the back of a car or in an airplane or you can do it all day long.
So you do these exercises while you're traveling?
Yeah. Commercialized a lot of times, and people are always talking about something about exercise, but exercise can be done all day long.
Well, let's see it, Alex.
Well, so basically, abdominal work, if I'm in an airplane or I'm on, you learn to control the muscle.
Three of us are in coach. Let's go.
And, okay. And what I do is I learn, you know, the only way I can describe it is you learn to tense your abdominals in the middle, and I tense them to the right, hold it for about 5 seconds, and I tense the left side. for about 5 seconds.
Doesn't that bother the person sitting next to you?
Well, you actually don't have to put your hands up. I was trying to show them how the muscles work when you tense them, but you don't have to actually do
all that. You got to do is tense them?
I do that.
Basic crunches.
I do that sporadically all day long when I travel and can't get to a gym.
You just keep tensing at the office.
You can do it. You just learn to control the muscle and tense them for about 5 seconds at least. And I learned to control the left side, which is actually your serratus in here.
Yeah.
And then the right, side as well.
What do you do for your pecs?
Oh, that's a lot of times I can't get to a gym because I travel so much.
Yes, we heard about that. You're on the plane, you're on the train.
And I'll go, I can get a workout with push-ups or surgical tubing.
Show us! Let's take a look, Rex. Show me what you got, baby.
It's Lex.
Lex? Rex?
Well, you're gonna do it.
Yeah. You joining us, Kat?
I guess so. I don't know.
You get over there. I'll get over there.
I don't trust myself going down on the mat here.
Okay. The most basic, safe form of ab exercise is crunches.
Now, you do this, right? You do this when you're traveling, right? Okay. Go ahead, Lex.
Not to be redundant, but as I travel...
Are we still in coach?
Feet flat to floor.
All right.
Now, this is the most basic form. People want to put their hands behind their head and pull their neck. Don't do that. You leave your hands to your side, across your chest, across your stomach, or down at your sides. Either way.
All right.
And basically, all you do is try to bring your chest and abdominals towards your thigh. You only come up about 2-3 inches. Bring the shoulders off the ground and back down. Up.
Flexing while you do it.
Hold it for a second. Bring it back down. Up. Hold it for a second. Bring it back down.
I just thought of a tag team. Lex and Rex. I'm Rex and you're Lex.
Lex is the dog.
No, how about Flex?
All right, fine. This is good. Shall we go out with a little...
As you get more advanced, you can actually bring your feet up and cross them.
Yeah.
And what I do is then is I actually will bring my legs toward me a little bit as I crunch up. So
you feel that much?
Oh, more. This feels good, Lex.
Up, hold it for a second.
Oh, Lex!
We're getting short a little bit, but it's very fun.
The Bash at the Beach takes place July 13th. Are you ready to go now?
I'm ready to go.
Go get that help. And Dennis Rodman, okay? Thanks, Rex.
Really nice to meet you.
It'll be on pay-per-view on the 13th of July. Claudia Cohen coming up next.
It's Live with Regis and Kathy Lee. And it's going to be a knockdown, drag-out brawl when Regis goes head-to-head with the WWF Stone Cold Steve Austin.
You know who's here, don't you? He competed in the SummerSlam last night on pay-per-view.
And he lived to tell the tale, huh?
He lived to tell the tale. Stone Cold Austin, right here. Now, take a look at this video. Patty, shall we give it to you? Now, can you see that? Now, watch this. Huh? There's Stone Cold.
I'm going to do that on my next lullaby album.
Stone Cold looks a little bit better like that. Whoa! And here he is, the one and the only Stone Cold Steve Austin.
They got the Austin t-shirt.
Those always work for me.
Everybody's here.
How are you, big boy?
You started this last time.
Are we going to be friends? Can I sit here?
Yeah, if you're nice.
How about I sit
if
here?
If you're nice.
You want me to come get...
Yeah, maybe you should sit there. Okay, I'm dying to hear. Now, The Undertaker's a very formidable guy, you know.
Yes.
How did you subdue him? Which hold did you use?
We caught him off the top rope with somewhat of a low blow, then.
Is there such a thing as a low blow in your...
Sure there is, a bunch of them.
Really?
And then I hit him with a stunner, 1, 2, 3. That's the finisher.
Yeah,
that's
absolutely.
I'll give him credit. He kicked out of one of them, but I didn't cover him fast enough. But that shows what kind of guy he is. He's a tough act.
Now, let's talk about this Stone Cold Stunner.
Right.
What is that all about?
The stunner, not the stutter.
Stutter.
Yeah, there you go. Yeah. We can't do this, folks.
Listen to me.
You
don't want Gilman to see me. Give you $100 if you do it to Gilman.
Regis, I'm a WWF champ.
I'll give you $200 if you stick with Regis.
There you go. Okay. You missed out.
Okay, now wait a minute. Right side.
What do you want? What do you want? Want me to come after you?
No, I want you to come after me. I'd kill you. But if you want to know the stunner is, you got to wear a guy down. You know, right off the bat, you know, it's not
really
that.
You
got him worn down. The first thing I'm going to do to set it up is I'm
going to... Take it easy.
Easy. This is for the Regis, Kathy Lee Show. Right. Bam, I'm
There you go. Benny down here?
Yeah.
When I come here.
Hey, easy.
I know you got the injury. What I'm going to do is I'm going to. You're not doing very good with pain, are you?
Easy.
Well, that's what I'm telling you. We can do it.
Now you're flipping me over.
No. You're going to land like that, and you're just going to fall over.
And I fall home like that.
Oh, yeah. Oh.
Let me hold this up one more time.
You go
Stone
take care
Cold's
of that jaw.
Personal favorites right there, Stone Cold medal. Thank you, Stone Cold.
You're welcome.
There's no Terry Como on.
The Rattlesnake Stone Cold Steve Austin hooked it up with longtime rival Regis Philbin this past week on Live with Regis and Kathy Lee.
Everything's cool with you and me, right?
Well, all right, but I'm waiting for an apology. You know, you almost broke my nose.
Oh. Again, I'm sorry.
All right.
Everything's cool, right?
Everything's cool, baby.
Beautiful.
It's Funky Philbin. And why is Funky taped up and all tied up as well?
Stone Cold Steve Austin prevents another war with the belligerent talk show host.
Imagine that.
And WCW superstar Sting shows us his stuff. All next on Live.
And so we'll find out from Mike Jones actually what happened at that conference. Who else do we have?
We got David Arquette from Scream 3.
Oh, yeah.
One of your favorites.
You know, this guy almost looks like the mask in Scream 3 there, but that's Sting, one of the all-time most popular wrestlers. Could be coming on, too.
I don't get the wrestling.
Really?
They all seem to be very amiable guys when they come out here.
Yeah.
And even the women that we've had, very nice people. I just don't get why people are fascinated with wrestling. You've loved it forever.
Oh, I have. I mean, I really loved it years ago. It's gotten a little garish now. Yes, it was him. 67th Street Sam. Now down on 66th Street in that vendor's kiosk.
And God knows what magazines he's reading, you know? It's a scary thought.
Isn't that something?
Perverted groundhog.
Right, millions of fans know our next guest as World Championship Wrestling superstar Sting, but he's more than just a pretty face and a great body. He's also an actor. His latest flick is a TNT movie called Shutter Speed. So here's Steve Sting Borden. Gentlemen, this is what I need, a little goatee right here.
Well, that's an unusual one.
This is the only place I can grow hair on my face.
It is an unusual one, you know?
Well, I'm an unusual guy.
You sure are. Look at this face.
Yeah, I'll let you show them the
Were you a difficult child? Were you a sweet child?
What makes you think that?
I mean, just want to know, because I have children, I want to know what they're going to grow up to be.
Actually, no, I was very, very shy.
Were you?
Yeah, and reserved. Mm. Too shy.
And
yeah.
How'd you get out of that?
Well, you know what? I put this mask on and it helps
it
a lot.
It just helps.
Yeah.
Sure. You can be anybody you want behind that mask,
right? That's right.
Well, weren't you a blonde at one time?
Yeah, I had a blonde flat top haircut. Oh, you got Sting and Sting right there. This was my look for 10 years.
Who was that football player?
Brian Bosworth.
And yeah, that's
he
right.
wrote about me in his autobiography.
Did
too.
He say you copied his look?
He did. He said that he should have a piece of the gate in all of my events, but I was the first to have the haircut. So.
Yeah.
Well, settle down, Bos.
In this particular picture, you know, I'm sure you've heard it many times. There's the great singer Sting, and then there's the great wrestler Sting. So people ever confuse you?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
You've been to the NAPTI convention.
Yeah,
well,
sure.
Yeah, I was at NAPTI.
And here's a rare picture of the two of you together.
Yeah, that's the blonde flat top hair.
Yeah, so that's what you look like. But why change into a brunette at this point?
Well, brunette is my natural color. I just wanted a change. I was looking for a change.
Yeah.
All right, I got Kathy with that one, didn't I?
Well, you changed pretty good. Not bad at all. So, anyway, you always wanted to wrestle when you were a kid?
Actually, no. I didn't know any wrestlers living in Southern California. I knew the name Hulk Hogan, and that's it.
Is that right?
Yeah, I didn't know anybody. And I had this health club in Southern California, and somebody came in one day and said, hey, you'd be perfect. And I said, I don't want to do that stuff. Long story short, I ended up doing it.
Yeah.
So
they made you an offer you couldn't refuse, huh?
Yeah, I mean, I saw these arenas packed out, and I saw Hulk Hogan finally, and I got to see him wrestle, and all these guys. And I mean, I think it was a sports arena in Los Angeles, and there must have been, I don't know, 20,000 people just going crazy.
And did you wrestle the Hulk ever?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Many times, yeah. I think the biggest pay-per-view record is Hogan and Sting in 1998, I think. Starcade, 98.
Now, have you ever been badly hurt? I see a scar, a pretty big scar right there.
Scar is sworn in battle, Kathy.
Yeah. What was your worst injury?
I had this left knee reconstructed.
Yeah, you took it slammed down like that.
Yeah, you know, a lot of people say, is it real or is it fake? And I said, well, it's entertainment. And I remember the time you got hit with a chair and you did this and you did. I said, why'd you ask then, you know?
Yeah.
Very physical.
Lately, a lot of guys are being hit by chairs.
And there have been some tragedies, too, I mean. But
now everybody's got a chair. And then one time, the other night, I saw somebody with a garbage can.
Oh, yeah. It's, you know what,
anything
goes.
Are there any rules?
There are none. Yeah. There are none. The referee seems to be doing this all the time.
Yeah, right. And there you are, you know, on the other side behind him or something, doing whatever you're doing.
Getting creamed, yeah.
Well, we got to go to commercial, but I'd love to hear him howl before we do that, Reach, because I understand your howl is quite amazing.
Is this before or after the commercial break?
Right now. We want to howl.
Anytime you want, Precious.
Yeah. That's it. We'll be right back in a moment.
That groundhog gets around.
Gelman is annoying everybody in the neighborhood with that stupid groundhog thing there. But anyway, he's over there
Send
at Starbucks now
him,
having
please.
Coffee. All right, we have Sting the wrestler here, but you know what he really wants? He wants to act, okay? New movie coming out called Shutter Speed on TNT. And he's on there with Daisy Fuentes.
Yeah.
Who plays
your fiancé who's kidnapped, but you're a renegade L.A. cop, and you're there to find her, right?
That's right, yeah.
All right, so what's the clip all about?
The clip is my brother and I are all of a sudden forced to be on the same case to save my fiancé from the bad guys, and there's a lot of tension between the two brothers, and I'm making him squirm.
All right, good. Let's take a look at Sting. Steve Borden, the actor.
Hey. Bradford or Roberts get a hold of you?
Yeah, Bradford, talk to me.
And?
Are you sure you're comfortable with us working together?
If you're asking me to forget what happened between us, I can't.
That doesn't answer my question, Riley.
I need to find out what happened.
You know, Dad didn't even...
Don't even start. Right now, I've got a friend in the morgue. If it means working with you to find out what happened, I'll do it. But it changes nothing between us. The question is, Detective, are you professional enough to handle that?
Yeah.
Then I guess we can work together.
Not bad. Still showing me something.
Yes, hello.
Shutter Speed TNT on February 6th at 10 o'clock. Good job.
Thank you.
When we come back, we're going to take a look at the Scorpion Deathlock, okay?
That's right.
Back in a moment.
Coming soon, don't...
Scorpion Deathlock as performed by Sting at all of his wrestling matches. All right, so you get the guy down like this. Now what happens? Easy!
I hook him like this. Easy!
Okay.
Closed captioning sponsored in part by...
Now, Croissant Pockets has a tender and flaky bake...
Okay, stop.
Tomorrow on Live, Mr. Rogers and last-minute travel tips.
All right, this is WWF Superstar Cooking Week around here. Here's their new cookbook just out in the stores. Can You Take the Heat? Different recipe by a different wrestler, and all this week we've got them coming on the show. You're a wrestling
fan? Big people.
Oh, they're big people, is right, yeah. Now we have a very big lady, I guess. I haven't met her yet, but I've seen some film of her. And she is the current WWF Women's Champion. Here's Lita.
Hello.
nice to see you.
Hi,
this is Tammy Elliott from Green Bay, Wisconsin. Yes, wow. Lita. Nice to meet you. And where are you from?
I'm currently living in North Carolina right now.
Where were you born in?
Atlanta, Georgia is where
Atlanta,
I come
from. Atlanta, Georgia. You're a Southern Belle, huh?
Yes.
Good for you. Now, let me check out that tattoo. Is that the real McCoy?
This is it.
And who is that? Anybody I know?
I don't know. Maybe it's you.
Like a dragon, huh?
Right, something.
All right, fine. Ooh. So, how long have you been wrestling?
Really, really a newcomer. Less than 2 years, right around 2 years.
No kidding. Yeah. What got you into this?
I had friends who would always watch it, and I never quite understood why people did. And one day I actually sat down and I was like, oh, this is great. So.
And did you have to go to wrestling school and learn the...
Yeah, it's been a crash course since I've been in such a short time.
Sure. But, 2 years and you're the champion already.
What's it like being a lady wrestler and I don't know if you're dating or if you've got, you know, a
not much
gentleman.
Time for that, right?
Kind of intimidating.
Yeah, I'm single, you guys.
Yeah. Well, you're constantly surrounded by men. Would you date any of those wrestlers?
I don't want to blackball anybody, but no, I think I'll stay away from those guys.
All right, fine, sure.
I don't want to get hurt.
Do you have a special hold?
Oh, I've got a couple moves. Actually, the moonsault, you know, like a backflip, and maybe, you know, take you out there.
Gilman?
Oh, boy.
The Hurricane Rana, you know, I would, like, climb up
easy,
and...
Easy, baby, easy.
And get up, maybe, put right here around you and flip you around or something. I don't know.
We'll take your word for it.
Okay.
And when we come back, we're going to cook one of Lita's favorite dishes and her favorite recipe on the show. Did you beat China for this title?
No. I actually beat Stephanie McMahon Helmsley for the title.
Oh, that's right. Stephanie
the
McMahon.
The boss's daughter. Then.
Yes, the boss's daughter married Ooh. Triple H.
Right.
Oh, my gosh. Yeah,
that's a combination.
That was a big scandal there. but you beat Stephanie, huh?
Right.
But see, I see something shining
in
your mouth.
In there.
What
it's
is
not
that?
Chili, but...
No. Oh, a duck.
Two.
A couple of them.
Two.
Here's her tongue.
Don't worry, Mom. I won't do that.
All right, Lita, let's go to work. What
All
are you
right.
making here?
We got spicy black bean dip. You guys
okay.
like spicy?
Sure.
Okay.
We love spicy.
We start with the bacon here.
Okay.
And, you put this in here.
Chopped up bacon.
You don't need any oil because it'll, you know, you got this bacon here.
Mm-hmm.
Get this stirring around here.
No.
You? All the time.
I don't
always cooking.
You better learn. All right, so
and then, you know, you get this going 10 minutes.
Mm-hmm.
You want to do this until
okay.
it's brown.
And then?
You want to just chop this onion up. How about you?
Yeah, I'll do that, sure.
Right.
Be careful.
Great.
Be careful. Wow.
Perfect.
A lot of onion.
You just stand there. I'll do it.
Use the chop one.
Oh, you hear me? Yeah, I'm killing myself. We got the chop onion.
Throw this all in together here.
Tell me these things. What's next, baby?
All right, you're going to keep you know, messing around with this. Have a little fun with it.
Yes.
Until it's clear, about 5 more minutes.
All right.
Keep going with that there.
All right, so what's next?
All right, we've got to get the old...
Get the what?
Garlic press out here.
Oh. Garlic press.
I've never
using
used
it
one of
this
those.
Way.
Yeah.
Not this way.
Right.
Looks dangerous.
We'll put this
put
in here.
Put the garlic in there. Now watch what Lita does.
Go ahead, Lita. Show me.
All right. Good.
Squirt's all in there.
Okay.
All right.
Garlic is in there. And next.
All right. Then you could. No, we're not ready for that yet.
All right.
We're gonna take this stuff in here. Oregano.
Cayenne pepper.
Wow.
Chili powder.
Little chili powder.
Spicy.
When you're a wrestler,
and when you're making
you don't
it for
care.
Regis, you put a little extra cayenne powder.
Oh.
And turn up the heat there.
Mm-hmm.
All righty.
Okay, Lita.
Now we're ready for it.
That is together. I'm not kidding you.
Easy on the pepper.
Okay.
Oh, my gosh, is that strong?
Whoa.
Just throw these in here like
but not
this.
Strong enough for you, huh, Lita?
How come she's not coughing? We're coughing.
This is kid
we'll
stuff, huh?
All right.
And the tomatoes?
Throw these tomatoes in here.
Tomatoes?
You have to pour them into a clear bowl first,
right.
And then pour them in here.
Okay.
Otherwise, it'll taste totally different.
And here's the...
And throw those babies
the
in there.
Beans.
All righty.
My gosh, we can feed every wrestler in creation with that. And then finally it turns out like this right over here, right, Lita?
Yeah, and then you magically have a finished product here.
Is there a spoon here, Gilman? You never
I've got some chips.
Chips.
Oh, chips,
chip,
yeah.
Reed.
Okay, here you go.
Mm-hmm.
was
very good. Very tasty.
That is good.
Gosh, Hulks, it's so good to see you. You look so beautiful in blue.
Thank you.
Second time you've remarked on Hulk and how beautiful he is in blue.
I know. I can't get over it.
I can't believe this still works.
Yes. Yeah. Boy, did you have a ball with that, huh?
Oh, my gosh. For years, they
were. In that Madison Square Garden never rocked. It was never more noise in Madison Square Garden than when you were wrestling there.
It was so loud, it used to make my jaws water in the middle of the ring. It was fun.
And you were out. You were out cold. Nobody could revive you. And then suddenly, they play that music.
Close.
And then you see one of
Hulk's fingers. They're playing a theme from Rocky?
The finger would start to move, and then you knew there was still life.
Yes.
Oh, God. Gilbert and I used to go, we loved it.
I told you this before, my very first celebrity sighting ever in New York, I was working on the soap, and all of a sudden, out of nowhere, appears Hulk Hogan, and you were going to do the Letterman show, and you just walked across the street, and people stopped, I mean, traffic stopped, everything stopped. You couldn't believe what you were seeing. It was the Hulk.
The fans are so loyal. And it's really cool because now it's like Brookamania is running wild. They're loyal to my daughter, too.
Oh, well, that's good, sure.
Yeah.
You passed it down.
What about this TV show? The whole family is under scrutiny, Hulk? Now, is that for you?
Well, it's kind of...
Doesn't that get on your nerves, Hulk? Don't you want to smash those guys? Break their camera? Huh?
Well, now that you put it that way, yeah. But it's the ripple effect is great for the family. I mean, you know, it's really kind of like poetic justice because now... I'll be in the mall and all the people will come running right at me and they'll go right by me to my wife, Linda. And I go, all right.
Well, now they're all exposed. But now you moved from Tampa, right?
Yes, sir.
That was a beautiful house you had in Tampa, right?
Well, we still have the house there. And that's where we filmed the first two episodes. Mm-hmm. But the third season, we're filming in Miami kind of because my daughter's career was there. And Scott Storch and Cecil Barker, who run the company, are there. So we figured we needed to be hands-on with that.
Mm-hmm. Sure.
And my son Nick, who just turned 16, is now driving the Viper for Dodge. So it's kind of really scary.
Wow.
But all the racing's down that in that area.
And a lot going on in Miami. And so how do you like it there?
Well,
you strut on the beach, you strut on South Beach?
Well, I've tried to go to the beach, but it's tough, you know, because like I said, there are Hulkamaniacs everywhere. And even though they mean well, they're very aggressive, you know, so it's kind of like hard to hide.
Do people just come up and try to wrestle with you? Do they
think? No. They come up and they're very nice, and then they want autographs and they want pictures, and it's really cool that it's still happening. I mean, it's really neat.
Right. Sure it is. We're going to take a break. We'll come right back with more.
Tomorrow on Live from the film The Quiet, actress Alicia Cuthbert. And also, we'll see what happens when Regis gets together with Don Rickles.
Shape it up! Hulk Hogan with us. What's new with the wrestling, Hulk?
Well, you know, I got injured a couple days ago. My wife bought a new couch. And I was kind of like sitting in this deep, dark hole in the living room and with a coffee in my good hand. And this was my good leg. The knee replacement's over here. I went to push up with my left hand. I should have put the coffee down and used both hands. All of a sudden, there was this big pop in the end of my knee. So it's kind of like a little meniscus tear, and I'm nursing it. I can walk, but I can't go upstairs. You know what injuries are like.
Well, I've got a hamstring here that went to you to be in the hospital with this.
It's incredible, too, because I was counting on the two of you wrestling each other like you normally do.
What was the worst injury you ever had in the ring?
Probably the worst injury was at WrestleMania 3 when I tried to get Andre up. I couldn't do it.
Oh, yeah.
Then the second time, I got him here, and they said he was 500 pounds. He was closer to 700 night.
No kidding.
And when I got him here, I didn't think I'd get him, but I just went the heck with it. And when I turned him like this, this whole part of my back tore under my armpit. So that was the worst one. That hurt.
Yes. But you're still wrestling, aren't you?
I'm still trying. I'm making an attempt. And right now, you know, I'm scheduled to wrestle in a couple weeks. And it's kind of like touch and go with the knee. So we're kind of playing it by ear.
And he's got a big birthday coming up this week.
Easy.
I know, Hulkster. We don't like
Hulkster. We buy the Hulkster.
What would you like for your birthday, Hulkster?
What would I like for my birthday? It's been so crazy around my house with the cameras and VH1 and my daughter's music and my son's stuff. and all the animals. I wish everybody put a piece of duct tape on their mouth. Just for one day. Just so it would be like so peace and quiet for one day. Yeah. Even me, I need to shut up too.
Hey, let me ask you, does your wife still have that chicken? The chickens?
Yeah, my wife does. We've got all the animals down in Miami, and so we're breaking the neighborhood there. And, you know, it's just, they're getting used to it.
Now, what are you in town for? What's going on?
Well, we got Pokemon, 10th anniversary.
Yeah.
You know,
10
my son started with that. You know, he was so dedicated. It's like a really cool video game and stuff. You know, some of the stuff that's out there.
Yeah. Right,
I mean, this is safe for the kids, and they deal with the Starlight, the Make-A-Wish kids.
Yeah.
I mean, so they're really cool people.
Where's
to be
the
with.
Celebration?
Bryant Park.
Oh,
it's
Bryant
all day
Park.
Long, and I'm going to be out there with
it's
all
from
the...
10 a.m. to 4 p.m.
All day today, Pokemon 10th anniversary. And the host will be there in Bryant Park.
You
see the Billy on coming up next.